This is crazy. They just abandoned the stream. I'm going to go get the mail, and I'm going to show you some examples of crazy mail that I've gotten. And I can't go live on Facebook tonight for some reason. It won't let me. Got a haircut. Don't really know if I like it or not. I guess it's just dry. It's just not in the right spot. It's drying. But anyway, I got a haircut. And what else? Because somebody told me, get it. Get a haircut and do just the sides. So pretty much that's what I got. Very bad connection. 30 seconds into this bad boy and I'm bad. Here's my shirt somebody sent me. Beer. It's your friend. Beer. Can you guys comment? Wow, this is awesome to live chat. Hey, Leah Lafferty. I'm going to go get my mail, all right, Leah? It might stop for a second, but if it does, I'm coming right the hell back. Facebook won't let me go live tonight. I don't know if I was naughty. Like your hair, I'm a hairdresser. I date hairdressers and nurses, and that's about it. Seriously, in my whole life, that's all I date. Hey, Stephanie, I missed you. You're never on Facebook anymore. I was wondering how you are and what's going on. Hold on. Hey, Melody, what's up? Regine Mitchell. Check out that. It's creepy. All right, it might cut off for a second, but I'll be right back. I'm under Stephanie Renee. Oh, I try to reply to every down. They go way down to, can you guys see the moon tonight? Check out that, it's creepy. I know you see the light, wait a minute. Let me take you over this way. Shoot, there's the moon. Ow, look at that. I'm at the mailbox. I'll show you what I got today. The moon is full. I didn't think it was supposed to be full till like the end of the week. I got another countdown. And that's that. You can't hear me. Hold on. I'm going to put headphones on. You only date hairdressers and nurses. Well, I surely qualify. Message me. I'm interested in you. What are you interested in knowing? Want to see the moon? I'm interested in long walks. Looking at people's Halloween lights that are still up. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Long moonlit. Oh shit, I smell skunk. Either that or my neighbors are smoking a little reefer. I get too fucking paranoid to smoke that shit. I had a bunch of, can you guys hear me all right? I shit that I got mailed. So here's like that. And I got some mail from the church. So let's go into Chris's little part of the world. This is what I get mailed. I get mailed all kinds of shit. Here's an example. Let me plug you back in, ladies. La la li la. Hold on. I get hats. I get the sock monkey and the sand chap. I get hats made. I get shit from Australia. A boomerang. Yes, fan mail. Call it fan mail. I don't call you guys fans. I call you guys my friends, and I hope that you feel the same way. I am shitty. I'm gonna apologize. I am like the shittiest person to get back to anybody, when they message me in real life. I want to send you something. I'm afraid, I don't give out my address because I don't want somebody to send me any gynecological supplies like they did with Maria or a snake. That's awesome. I love that. Let me show you some stuff. So I took a shower and somebody sent me this, they sent me this shirt. Hold on. I'm loading a video now that is right before this, but somebody, I was getting dressed I was right out of the shower and you missed it, ladies. It's going in and out. I'm right here and I'm not going anywhere. You must send your address, babe. Somebody sent me this shirt. Beer, it's my friend. Look at that. Yep, Beer is my friend. So I figured I'll wear it. Then I went and I'm putting on my slippers, right? I got Mucklucks. They're really friggin' sturdy slippers. I don't know if you can see the little tag, but they're called Mucklucks. Mukluks. Muckluck. And I love my slippers. But somebody sent me, they know I love sock monkeys. They sent me sock monkey slippers. What the hell? Maybe I can Tom Cruise in these in my living room. Dun, 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 dun. Look at them. They got skids and everything. How do I get rid of the... How do I not want to see the comments? I don't know how to... I don't know how to get them out of there. So I can't see what I'm doing. But check out the little skids on these, right? Should I put them on or not? What is that? I would never send anything nasty or vile. I seen a fireball cake on Facebook the other day. Love them. I have a pair of Mukluk boots. I love these. They are boots. They are slippers, but they're boots. Check them out. You can tie them in the back and make them tight just in case you gotta, just in case you're going up the friggin' hill, right? I don't like them tight like that, but hold on. I like them a little bit. My cat was playing with this damn thing earlier. This is how I have the other one. It's already set to go. And I love it because I look at the bottom of them. I zoom around the house. I Tom Cruise style in my fucking boxer shorts. You want to try it? Dun, 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 dun. But somebody sent me these bad boys. People send me stuff. Now, I want to start this trend of resending the shit that you're never going to wear. And here's some examples of cards I've got. This was in a package recently, a package to me. It's a cute little card with a little love note in it from some sweet, sweet woman. She's very fucking beautiful. She's got beautiful eyes. She's beautiful. Love her hair. Love everything about her. Not only just physical features, but she's a really sweet girl. And she sent me a little love note, and she says, I love you, I love you, I love you. I'll just show you a little bit of that. I love you, I love you, can you read that? I love you, I love you. I love spreading, oh, there we go. I got fur in my mouth. I love you. Yep, that's it. So, I love women. They're fucking beautiful. What can I say? You know, they're fucking sweet. Here's another one. This one comes from Rhode Island. Not going to show you who sent it, but this is from Rhode Island. Pawtucket, Rhode Island. Tap your screen. The comments will go away. Thank you. But I don't know how to get them back when I want to see them. I want to see the comment. Here's another one. This is a birthday card. Under the whiskers, past the gums, look out, litter box, here it comes. It's a cat drinking beer. What the fuck is that shit? All right, let's go. Cheers, ladies. Stephanie, I am very happy to see you. I wonder about you because I saw people brutally bashing you on Facebook, and it's fucking wrong. I started a video earlier, and I was starting to say it. You know, it's okay to joke with people in good humor, but when you make somebody cry and you hurt their feelings, that's different. That's fucking wrong, and you're a fucking bully. You're not a comedian. You're not the funniest person on the planet. You're a piece of shit. Sorry if I'm mean, but people were bashing Stephanie a while back on Facebook, and it was fucking wrong, and I'm not even gonna sugarcoat it or deny it. It was fucking wrong, and she ended up taking a Facebook vacation, and I don't blame her. I take them too. Thank you so much. It was very hurtful. It was very fucking rotten. Hey, happy birthday, Stephanie. La la lila. You should go on Facebook, though. I made a new page. It's a page. It's not a group. And it's called Chris Rage. That's it. Just Chris Rage. Type it in and then scroll where you'll see groups. And then when you get to pages, then there it is. Find me there because I'm doing this giant freaking pearl party. And it has to do with YouTube, too. But if you want to go to the pearl party, you got to get on Facebook because I don't know. Now, seeing how Facebook is today, I can't go live. What if I plan to do the pearl party and I can't go live? Then I'm here, you know? Does anybody know how long this live YouTube-ish thing goes? So anyway, it's your birthday. Bottoms up. People write me the sweetest things. Watch this. I'm gonna show you this card and I'm going to let you read it. Chris, I'm so happy to have you in my life. I feel blessed. Let me tap this and see if it goes away. Nope. It won't go away. Let me tap the comments. Oh, hey, hide all chat messages. Hold on. Chat hidden. Look at what it says. Very happy to have you in my life. Now, that is some sweet shit. I get a bunch of sweet shit, and I'm not even going to lie. I think it's sweet that you guys think of me and you want to send me things, but in reality, I would just be happy if you messaged me and say, Chris, you know what? When I woke up today, I thought, you know, I'm going to do something nice for somebody else. Even if you just hold the door for the neighbor that you don't like. You know, his name is Max, and he scratches his junk, and he smells bad, and he probably works in a garage and chain smokes. Even if you don't like him, and he spits as soon as he gets out of the building, and he's just disgusting to you. Even if you just hold the door for him one day, you know, that's a point for you. And you know what? It just makes you look better to God. But I'm not going to preach any God to you guys because I know how you are. I just recently opened a Christmas card I found. It was addressed to me and my ex-wife. And I finally figured after 2 friggin' years, I'm allowed to open the mutual mail. Fuck that shit. So there it is. I don't even know what it is. I opened this a month ago. I shit you not. All right, I got another thing. I got one from Nova Scotia, Canada. Let me show you this. Here, I'm not going to show you who sent it, but it is from Nova Scotia. You can clearly see that. And, ta-da, right, check this out. People send me, I don't know why. Oh, this was a birthday card to somebody. It's got a song. This is check it out. Anyway, happy birthday, buddy. Pretty sweet. I know it was my birthday, but some of these aren't birthday cards. They're just cards. I want to put them in my wall of, my little wall thing behind me. Here's another one. Another one from Canada. You know those Canadian ladies, La La Leela. How do I show you this without showing you this? Here's another one. All right, there we go. The zip code in Canada is like EIC or 1C. Can't begin to keep up with all the nice things you do. Oh, this is a thank you card. I sent somebody a bunch of stuff. I'm sending stuff, and I want you guys, if you're going to send me cards with lips on it, I want that, all right? I want it. Give me a card with a lip on it. Take a piece of paper and put your perfume on it, stuff it in an envelope, slap a stamp on it, and I will hang it up on my wall. I got Pretty Patsy. She's going on my wall, even though she says I'm two-faced and I'm a backstabber or whatever. I never said one bad word about that woman, and I've always stuck up for her. But yet, she goes on her wall and she says rotten things about me. What is that? That's childish and stupid, and I don't even know who told her. I know who told her. There's a woman out there named Nikki, and she's obsessed with me, and she's fucking cuckoo. That's who told her. Here's Pretty Patsy's pictures, by the way. All this stuff is going on my wall behind me. Pretty Patsy sent me a couple pictures, right? She autographed them, you know, because I love Chris, all my love. Pretty Patsy, this is my good luck charm right here. She's fucking beautiful. If you want to see somebody beautiful, I'm not beautiful. Don't send me love letters. She's fucking beautiful. She's fucking beautiful. The woman, I sent this woman, I thought she's, in September, she said on her page, send me a self-addressed stamped envelope. I'll give you an autographed picture of me. Well, I said, you know, she's paying for these pictures herself. I might as well help her out. So I sent her $20. No big deal. I just slapped it in there with a little note. Said, you're doing something nice. You're a great person. I love your energy. Get yourself a coffee. Do you know what this woman did? Instead of going to get a coffee, she got a coffee. She bought 3 cases of water and handed them out to the homeless. Now, if that's not a fucking good person, I don't know who the fuck is. You know, you guys think, whoever voted for Trump, please stop watching me. You guys think Trump is this great fucking American. He's a selfish asshole who can't even hold the fucking door for his wife. But anyway, and she sends me a letter dated September 25th. And it's such a sweet letter. Here we go. How nice it was for you to send money for me to have a coffee. Very sweet. And I did indeed just that. So thank you. With the rest, I delivered 3 cases of water to the homeless. So we really thank you for your love and caring for others in life. That's what's missing. God bless you, my dear. Pretty Patsy, 2017. And Stormy. So this woman is fucking sweet. You think I'm nice. I'm an asshole. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm kind of an arrogant fucking asshole. Pretty Patsy, though. I mean, I don't know what made her get mad at me. I don't understand it. But anyway, I might give away the Sock Monkey slippers because I have a pair of slippers. Maybe they're summer slippers. Maybe these are kind of winterish. I don't know. I might give those away, but I'm going to give this away. I've been cleaning up my hoarding complex. And in order, you know, I'm doing the Pearl Party. I didn't do the Pearl Party. I've been doing kind of mini ones up to this point randomly on my Facebook. And I've been going through my hoarding complex and anything that you need, like Carrie the other day. Right? Listen to this. I found a weed pipe. I'm sending this to my favorite stoner friend, Sherry. Hold on, I'll show you. Look, she's going to get this whole box of paraphernalia. Look at it, it's a grinder. I don't smoke weed, so you might as well just have it. So I'm sending this out. It pays to be my friend on Facebook because if you find something in my house that you need, I'm going to mail it to you. I signed up for the Buddha box. It's BUDDABOX for my friend who's got cancer. And so, she obviously doesn't need it because she wants the edibles. That's it. She's like, I don't want to smoke the weed. I want the edibles. So, there's a whole ton of shit. There's lancelets. There's all kinds of crap in this thing. There's a giant box that's going out to her because she's special and amazing. And it pays to be my friend. I don't call anybody a fan. You guys are friends. Another thing, I found this TENS unit, right? And this thing fucking electrocuted the shit out of me. I'll turn it on. It's got a shitload of pads. It does acupuncture. I'll tell you what this does. Stroke, massage, acupuncture, manipulation, scraping, cupping, weight reducing, hypnogenesis, adjusts your blood pressure, immunotherapy, and it also does, what is this? What is the four things it does? Wait, there's one thing I'm missing. Acupuncture, did I list that? So anyway, I was on there the other day, and Carrie's on there. I want to be friends with everybody, and if nobody likes it, you can take a flying hike. I'm friends with Maria, I'm friends with the haters, it's fine, I'm friends with everybody. I don't really want to hate anybody, I'm not a hater. I'm going to read the comments in a second. Whoa, it's hot in here. So, one of Carrie's friends, I believe it's Karen, what's her name, Sue Cole or something like that, but I see that girl on Maria's page, and I don't know if there's a conflict, but I'm not going to tell Carrie I'm not, you know, going to send something and then not send, and I'm sending the thing. So anyway, you don't even know the amount of packages I got. Me and Maria, I got us brand new Schmuel hats, right? These are going out. Let's check these bad boys out. Hold on. Let me find mine. I don't know what I did with it. Here it is. Here you go. Watch this. When Maria is over in Potsdam, this is going out to Maria. When Maria is in Potsdam, this is mine. She said she wants the Velcro. Mine has that crap on it. When Maria's in Potsdam doing her own thing, whatever she wants to do on a Friday night, la la Leela, she's going to get this, right? And she's going to be doing her own thing. It's going to be me and Maria. We're going to be schmueling, but she's going to have her own new hat, and she's going to schmuel where she's at, and I'm going to schmuel where I'm at, and it's going to be nice. Some other things, by the way, I'll show you. If you haven't been paying attention, let me unhide the chat. If you haven't been paying, oh, wait a minute, I can't get you back. Show live chat. Sorry, guys. I wish there was a hairy clit video. I went on Craigslist earlier, and there is some hairy clitness, by the way. There's somebody out there looking for a hairy clit. It could be a marriage made in heaven. I made a match. Chris, it's Stephanie Renee. I have a black shirt and blonde hair. Find me on Meridian, Mississippi. All right, I will. So these are a couple things in the Pearl Party. It pays to fucking get on that Facebook page. Pay attention, because I run random contests. Like, I might get on that page and say, what color hat was I wearing yesterday? You're the first one to answer. You go to the Pearl Party. You can only win once per contest, but you can win more than once. And I've got some people like Joan Ann Smith over here. She's racking it up. Here's what's going to Maria. It is a pink pearl, medium pink color, with angel wings and a little balloon on a cute little necklace for her. She's going to be wearing that, styling over in Potsdam. Oh, I like it because the comments go away after you guys write it. That's kind of cool. So when you go to the Pearl Party, this is just a sample. I did Maria's already because I'm not going to do the Pearl Party with Maria. She has a boyfriend, and I'm not going to fit into that mix in her kitchen. If I go visit her, and I want to go visit her, that is on my bucket list. I want to be in that kitchen. I'm dying to see what's going on in that kitchen. I want to sit there like a fly on the wall and watch the leg kick. You want to see? I've been practicing my leg kicks, ladies. So check this. This is going out to Maria, too. It's a snowflake. All right? Because I'm snow, and that's just it if you need to find me. Why do I look like I'm sweating already? Look at my shirt. It looks like it's dirty. It's extra large. People are like, what size are you? I think every t-shirt's... Look at this thing, looks giant on me. This is like my second time wearing this shirt, but I wanted to show you guys some of the crazy things people send me every freaking day. I tried finding your face. Go on the search bar, type in Chris Rage, and then where it says groups, whatever... Scroll over to the far right, and it'll say pages, and then click pages, the little tab up there, and then you'll see it. You might need to update your Facebook, too. I am sweating in this hat today, but I like it. I like it. I look like I'm back from the 80s. I look like Will Smith, the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. I took my cologne, but I said, I don't want Maria to argue with her boyfriend, so this is a guitar, because she says rock on, right? I don't want Marie to argue with her boyfriend, so last night I took my cologne. You missed it if you didn't see the Facebook video, but it's live and I posted it. I took my cologne and squirted it on a little pom-pom ball, stuck it in the middle of this because none of her pearls would fit. Check out the guitar. And look, my cologne all sealed up. She'll be wearing it. She's going to think it's essential oil. It's essential Chris. It's Chris's scent. Yep. Mm-hmm. No, nothing better to ward off a man than Chris's scent. All the men will come. They'll go running because they don't like the smell of it. It's kind of like if you love something, you pee on it. I think that's what dogs do. You know, they go up to the hydrant and shit. Anyway, this is for Maria. This is going out. I've got a crap load of stuff in my house that I find and I want to mail away, and I mail it. Anyway, that's going for Maria. But I came across this today. Now, I'm going through my crap, and I got my favorite Australian friend that sends me stuff. I came across this today. I'm going to send this to her for her little beautiful granddaughter, Maya. Sock monkey hat, because it gets cold in Australia. And then, hopefully, she can wear this when she, like, starts walking for a little costume. So she'll be walking around like Lalila. That's going out to Susie. But I come across this random hat today. I'm not going to have any kids. If you guys know anybody that's pregnant and you want them to wear this when their little baby pops out, tell me who the fuck you are. I'll send this to you in the mail. And there you go. Look at that. I did something nice for you today. Let me check my mail. I got some mail from the church. Today is a good day for you. It is the first day of the rest of your life. God has plans for you and your future. The writing is on the wall. This is my mail I get. I just don't try to get my address, creepers, because you're not going to get it. I am like Fort Knox with my address. You gotta, unless you've got a package there with my name on it and ready to go all sealed up, I'm pretty much not going to tell you where I live. And I'll tell you why. Somebody sent the ambulance here at 4:30 in the morning. So I'm all set with giving my address. I'm done with that. I thought, ha, 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 yeah, I'll trust you. Ha, ha, no, I'm not doing that. So here we go. I got another lovely, beautiful card from Canada. Let me, I want to block the address so you creepers won't bother this poor girl. Another from Canada. La, la, li, la. Let's check out the stamp. The Canadian stamp. They pay $1.20 to get this shit to me. Just a damn card costs $1.20. Don't think I don't appreciate it. Listen to this. My friend gave me a bag full of shit today. We're going to go through that in a minute. You know, it's nice to do things for your friend. Why can't I see any comments unless there are not? Let me press the comments. Show live chat messages. There we go. You know, it's nice to do stuff for your friends. Oh, I think this is a thank you card. You went out of your way and it was out of this world. Oh, it's got little stars on it. I get a thing for stars, you know. If you saw me last night wearing my little hat. Ooh, wait a minute. Look, somebody sent me some. Look. You think you might get some crazy fucking mail? What the hell? This is my mail. This is it. Ooh. Bottle up. I got sperm in a package. Some woman was touching her play hole and putting it in here for me. Chris, this is it. I don't have Facebook, too much drama for me. Well, I don't know how you're going to join the pearl party. You won the other day. You were kissing your boyfriend. You won the Comcast, by the way. Peace and love. You said Comcast for the contest for the four different things. You won peace and love, so I don't know how I'm going to find you when we do this pearl party thing. We're going to have to work something out. Maybe me and you can one-on-one chat or some shit like that if you want. I mean, if your boyfriend doesn't get jealous, have him there. We'll have a three-way. Fuck it. Yes, peace and love. You won. You are number 35. And yes, I got you up on my wall right here in the background, kissing girl picture. You are there, yep, mm-hmm. This leaked. I love you more beyond than words can explain. I've got leakage in my, smells pretty good though, pretty damn good. This is fucking amazing. Want me to read this card? Chris, if I could reach up and hold a star for every time you made me smile, the entire evening sky would be in the palm of my hand. Where do you get this shit, ladies? Where do you get the things that you say? What is a pearl party? A pearl party is Chris buys a bunch of pearls, the things that pearls go in, like you just saw for Maria, the cages, and then bracelets or necklaces, and I pay the postage. You pay for zero. You don't pay a fucking thing. What happens is on Facebook, I'm going to announce the time. Maybe I'll do it live on this. I haven't, this is my very first time going live on YouTube. I don't know how it works. I didn't even know if people could comment, but I was going to do it live on Facebook, and everybody can kind of comment what they like. Let me show you what some pearls look like. I opened up a shitload. You really should go on Facebook because that's where it's at. That's where most of the contests are. I don't really do YouTube like other people. I'm not a YouTuber. I'm sorry that I'm not. You know, if I was, I'd be making tons of money. I made $5 in a month. I mean, that was only, I only put two fucking videos on there. I don't understand it, but I'll show you. Last night, I sending Maria some, look at what I'm sending her. I'm sending Maria some Bubblicious here. Strawberry and bubble gum. Yeah, she's going to be chewing it up. Be like, Chris, I want to blow bubbles. I want to have a little bubble contest on Shmuel, you know, or something, something, something. I want to have some fun. Let me show you some of the pearls, though, the colors. We opened them last night, just a few, and they went in, basically, they went in a pot. And then if you get a pearl and you don't like the color, because it's a crappy color or whatever, you're allowed to go into the pot, and you're allowed to take the pearl that you got, you win, and switch it for something else. So here's a bunch of them. We opened them last night live. I cut my finger. Peace and love. She has a video on her YouTube. Wait. I just got home from a 10-hour drive to So you live in New Hampshire. I live in Mass and she lives in Laconia. I live right near the border. Peace and love. She has a video on her YouTube page about the pearls, cages, and necklaces. Watch the video, Chris. I don't know what you guys are talking about, but you go on Friday and Saturday and Sunday on Facebook. You can go to AWE Awshucks, S-C-H-U-C-K-S, Awshucks Mom and Awshucks Sister. Find them. They're pearl dealers out of Kalo and Company. Just go and watch a fucking pearl party. You're going to pay $19-$20 for a fucking pearl. You're going to pay at least $20 for a cage. And then you're going to pay $20 for a bracelet or a necklace or whatever the hell. At least $20 for it to go with. So, you're in Mass, which is cool. I live right on the border. So last night we opened up some oysters, and these are some pearls that we have that are going to go into the pot. So if you get a pearl you don't like, you're going to be allowed to switch it for a pearl. It's going to be a fun party. Nobody pays for anything. Let me show you what some of the cages look like in case you don't have a freaking clue. I've got, let me show you. If you just missed it a little while ago, I had Maria's on there. But I don't know if you can watch this live later. I really don't know how YouTube works. Here's a starfish. Here is a snowflake. And so the pearl goes in there. Then the pearl goes on a necklace and then or a bracelet, and then you wear it. My favorite, I don't know if I have any left. I don't think so. I think Melanie got the last skull. You know what one of my favorites is, though? We got some guns. But the thing is, if you get a big pearl that's too big, it might not fit in this hole, the gun. I purposely bought these for one of my friends on Facebook. I had this party for all of my friends first, and then I realized I might as well just do it for strangers. Nice people that are nice to me. I was like, huh, because lately my messages I wrote had been very weird messages to people that I would never write, like I'm hacked thinking, I don't know. Angels, Chris. I put that on the list. Check out this. I've got one pufferfish left. I want to order more pufferfish because they're beautiful and amazing. They're cute. Look at that. Is that not the cutest little thing in the world? So there's some jewelry, and yeah, that's what the pearl party is going to be like. You don't have to pay for a damn thing. But you gotta, in order to go to it, you gotta win something. You gotta win a contest. That's all. I don't ask for you. I don't ask for titty pictures. I did ask last Saturday for pussy pictures. But that's besides the point. That's a different, whole different. It wasn't in a dirty way at all. I just said, show me your dirty pussies on the thing. So anyway, we did have a hairy clit contest too. Yeah, that went on too. You just had to, you didn't have to show your hairy clit like Maria. All you had to do was basically admit that you have a hairy clit, because I've never seen one. And apparently tonight on Craigslist, I had seen go on Craigslist Boston, Massachusetts, and type in casual encounters, scroll, and you will see somebody, they're searching for a hairy clit. So it could be a marriage made in heaven if somebody wants a hairy clit and they're looking for one or whatever. Meow! That's my safe word, by the way. So I'm reading my little cute little card I got. You are a star like no other. You will never know how much I love you until you can enter in my heart and feel what I feel. I am truly blessed to have you. Oh, this is so sweet. I'm such a prick. You know, I go through my day and I hustle and I bustle and I drink beer and I do it and I eat bananas and I chat with women and this and that. And then I get a card like this and I think this is so sweet. Somebody actually took their time to write these precious little words. I'm going to put these cards all behind me. I'm getting rid of this California wildfire shit behind me. I was supposed to do it in Halloween, but Chris procrastinates like nothing. How do I see comments? Here we go. Wait a minute. Hey, Melanie. Now, this is what sucks, Melanie. We can't go live together like we did the other day on Facebook Land. We may be far away from each other, but I know that every night we see the same stars, and it makes me feel closer to you. Thank you for everything. Oh, that is so sweet. Look at that. I can't make this up. Maria is live now, you guys, on Facebook Land. It's Maria Haley, in case you haven't paid attention. She's had a boyfriend now for a month. I'm not going to lie. He looks like Charles Manson, but, you know, maybe he just likes the look. Maybe the look is he thinks is intimidating. He is a biker, though, so I don't want to have him on my bad side. I am sweating my head off, but you can tell I got a haircut, right? Well, at least I look okay. Look at this hat looks so big right now. I'm just going to, whatever. All right, forget it. So I don't know. This is I've never smelled anything like this. It almost smells like a vanilla candle, and it leaked all over. I can't thank you enough for every little thing you did for me, your smile, your kind words towards me. I love you beyond words can explain. XOXO. But you didn't sign your name. Why? Why not sign your name? I mean, I know who you are, but there's no name. Why not? Who forget? I know. I've got a little meme to post about turning your clocks back, ladies. What? Maria has a new boyfriend? That's why you need to be on Facebook Land for the past month. Oh, look at my little curl. They missed one. For the past month, Maria has been dating a man, K-R-I-S-T-O-F-F-E-R, Christopher Haley, H-A-L-E-Y. It's not under Chris Snow, it's under Chris Rage, R-A-I-G-E. Go under Chris Rage, and then when you go under that, it'll say pages, groups, I don't even know if, what else. What else is there? People, pages, groups, places, things. People, places, things, all that shit. It's under pages. Then hit the page tab, and then boom, I'll be right there, and you'll find me. And I only have 300 friends, and that's all I need. Where'd she meet this guy? I don't know. She's the guy. The guy mate was the one that made out with her back when Wes was around, still kicking. I did that. I don't know why you can't find it. I'm adding this hard to my little catastrophe behind me. I hope he treats her okay, and I wonder what he looks like. I don't know what he looks like. He looks like Charles Manson. Go find him. Go type it in. You'll see. I can't post any pictures here, can I? Going to try again. I'm leaving the tag on my hat. I don't even care. That's how cryptic I am today. I don't know where she met him. Maybe Dunkin' Donuts. That's the only thing in Pottville that there is. There's Dunkin' Donuts. By the way, in case you missed it, ladies, sorry, I'm burping in your face. Don't eat these, all right? These are poisonous. These have genetic materials in them. It's not GMO free. Do not eat this shit. It's poisonous. I put it on my page. Go look. I'm downing, and I eat these every day. I'm not sitting here like this, you know, going, hey, I'll chug it up. I live alone. I love it. I know you guys have grandkids, you have one-year-old babies that are learning how to eat. No. Now this is what's for dinner for Chris. Chocolate Twinkies, and hold on, you want to see what I just bought? I'll take you, oh, I'm going to show you the bag full of crap my friend gave me. This is nice to have friends that have stuff that they have that they want to give you. I'm starting a new trend. If you have shit that you don't want, Give it to somebody else. Don't hoard it. Give it away. Give it. And one person's trash is another's treasure. Even if you gotta give your boyfriend to somebody else because you're sick of them. You do that. What I love, do not go and buy the Hostess fucking cupcakes anymore. Buy Entenmann's. These friggin' Entenmann's cupcakes are the best. Look at how they're the best. I'm telling you, no more Hostess. Do not buy the Susie Hughes. You will be terribly disappointed. I was very disappointed when I opened up these bad boys. Peanut butter Ho-Hos. Disgusting. I'm going to give this away to my friend's son. No Frankenberry. I know. I posted the no Frankenberries. I gave my Frankenberry to my friend's son. She goes, he's going to love it. I thought, I'm going to poison him away. There he goes. I'm an asshole. I'm not going to deny it. You want me to deny it? No, I'll own that shit. All right. Anyway, you, peace and love. You know, I know you might not like Facebook, but create a fake account. You know, that's what a lot of people do. They just create crumb donut. Oh, I love crumb donuts. Hate peanut butter. Well, I don't know. You know, I'm starting to figure out that I'm allergic. I usually have trail mix. It's over there. I don't want to grab it. But I've been noticing I've been wheezing after it, so I'm probably allergic. Why? This looks like I haven't showered. But if you watched the video that was right before this, I have showered. And I posted it on YouTube because something's up with Facebook. I took a screenshot and put it on my page. It will not let me go live. Yes, create a fake account. Make a fake email and just get on there. Even if it's just to go to the pearl party. It's going to be fun. It's not going to be freaking boring. Nothing I do is boring, isn't it? So anyway, my friend gave me a bag full of shit. And I thought, all right, well, these are mine. This is how I start. I love Pop-Tarts. I'm telling you, any Pop-Tart flavor that comes out, I am all over it. This is my new favorite, Jolly Rancher Cherry. This shit is better than the wild berry, better than the cherry, better than the raspberry, better than any of the fruity ones. I'm a riot. Well, you know, I want you to go to the pro. You're going to the pro party. You get a free pearl. So what do you want to do? I mean, what would you like me to do to satisfy you right now? Because you're on YouTube and everybody else is on Facebook. So I don't know how to get you over to YouTube. I mean, on Facebook, so you can get your pearl. You're gonna be like the one oddball that says, "Well, I'm not happy." My friend, she knows I always running out of. What do you call it? I'm always running out of vibrator batteries, so for my little bullet here. I'm not kidding. It's a Colt bullet. Look on YouTube, you'll find it. Anyway, she gave me this whole thing. It looks like one battery's missing, but no, it's really not. So somehow it's not missing. It's not even open. This is like a Christmas gift. True value, batteries. What you under? Chris Rage. Yes, perfect. You found it. She gave me this because she knows my allergies are beyond shit. Look at that. Look at that. Merry Christmas, Chris. Look. Forget it. Forget Benadryl. It's Waldrill. It's Walgreens Benadryl. How many are in? 365. This will last me a whole fucking year. Do you guys see the comments or not? What do you guys see on there? Do you guys see comments when you write or what is that? This is my wall drill. This is like one of the best things. I don't know what's better, the batteries or the... I'm leaving that right here. I'm going to take it with my bedtime medication. What else we got? Oh, we got 70 Zyrtec. Imagine how much this costs. This must be a pretty freaking penny. And it expires in 2019. That's freaking amazing. Look at that. This is enough to last me forever. Oh, wait a minute. There's something in here. A blue pill. We could take that for the fun of it. I wonder what this is. Dun, 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 dun. P525. Anybody want to look that up? Hey, if this is something good, I'm taking it now. And you'll see look at it. It says P525. If this, I'll take this now. If this is something good, you'll see my Friday night get a whole lot better. Cannot find you, sweetie. Sorry, I did exactly what you said. You never can have enough batteries. I have rechargeables right here. I'm not even shitting you. Here they are. I'm going to keep it real. Yeah, you can't. Look on the pill identifier. I can't. Pedro, what do you do? Oh, it's You're not Pedro, even though you could be Pedro. You got Pedro's glasses on. Who are you? I read your last name and not your first name. Afrin. I'm not putting this up my nose. Somebody else stuck it up their nose. This is like my friend just cleaned her cabinet. Take all my ex-boyfriend's shit away. Take his Claritin. There's a lot in there. Wow. No mystery pill in there. Da 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 na na na. Indoor and outdoor allergies. Well, that's nice. 70 tablets of that. She knew I was. Look at this. This has me written all over it. This is my life. Look how bad this shit is. I'm gonna take a picture of it. There's a lot of allergy meds. Somebody told me to take Afrin, by the way, but I'm not putting that up my nose. I'll end up getting some nose STD. Some Neosporin. You can never have enough of that. What the hell? I think she gave me all her ex-boyfriend's crap. I got some Flonase. Don't you need a prescription for that? Oh, it's children's Flonase. I'm not. This was up somebody's nose, too. That's going in the trash. What the hell? Claris spray. It's the same as Flonase. Flukio, whatever it is. Claris spray? Never heard of it. What is this? Aleve liquid gels. That's what I needed last night. I had a headache. I'll follow you on Facebook. I'm Jennifer Ann Riley. That's my name. Oh, these liquid gels look sexy. They look like a fun night. Ooh, shit. How many did I drop? Later on, I'll find random pills in the bed. I'll be like, all right, just might as well just take it. I'm not going to find the bottle. That was it. My friend. Oh, wait. Oh, and a tape measure. How fucking lovely. Oh, I guess this goes on that. Probably. Yeah, that's what. That was all about me. Yep. Allergy shit. That's fucking hilarious. Hey, Chris, just have a bunch of shit you need. All right. It's like Santa Claus. It's nice when your friends give you shit and they don't want it. That's friggin' awesome. So, I'm glad I can connect with you YouTubers. This is fucking amazing. This is my maiden voyage on YouTube. I've never been on this. I don't know how it works. But I'm glad this worked today. Is anybody out there having any beers? It is Friday night. It's 8 o'clock. Tylenol PM is the blue one. Oh, thank you. I'll keep that in the back of my mind. Chris, you want me to look the pill up? No, it's just one random pill, and I'm not going to take it. I don't even dare to touch any of that stuff. Somebody else touched it. Glad tried it. What did I try? Oh, YouTube. Hey, Chris, nice to see you live on it. Hey, Angela, I'm trying this because Facebook would not let me go live. I don't know if I got banned, blocked, booted, or whatever. I know I say a lot of F words. People let their young children watch me, and I don't think that they should. I'm against it, and people are like, no, they're really not paying attention. Well, when I'm slinging F-bombs, like, you know, I'm the Titanic is sinking here, and I just can't think of anything else to say. I don't know. I wouldn't let my kid watch this, no matter how old they are. Chris, I got the bottle out. I'm drinking out the bottle. You do that. You know what I don't like about this? We can't go live. You can't be live at the tattoo parlor, Melanie, while I sit here and have my beer and you can't have your wine. I bet you're in bed. You probably would love these sock monkey slippers. Look at them. They're beautiful. Hold on. There's a random hair. Aren't these amazing? Somebody took their time to order these, wait for them to come in, and then send them to me. Could you see me steaming around the house in those? All right. Oh, yeah. They didn't even ask me the size of my feet. They're kind of big. Deb is me 08. I know who you are. People watching me to drink out of the bottle. Let me see. I'm going to press this little three dots down here. Share, mute microphone. I don't know how to share this. Can I share this when I'm live and not ruin it? Let me try to share this. Not go anywhere. Hold on. Wait, hold on. Okay, so if I there, let me Facebook, Gmail, Messenger. Let me see if I can Facebook. Oh, it's letting me. Friday night testing. Oh, that's only for my friends on Facebook, though. It's not on my page. That's shitty. It posted. That's cool. They cute. Love them. The little things? You're big. You probably love those frickers. I don't even know, man. I feel bad taking a gift someone gave me and then giving it away, but I'm not going to wear this. This is a little too small for my head. It's cute, though. I only got two of these left. These puppies are like gold. If somebody came in my house and they said, I'm having a sugar attack, I need some sugar, I would never do this. I shared your live stream on Facebook. Jennifer Miguel Pedro. I wear a size 10, ladies. I've been with women and that's what they wear. They wear size 10. They've got giant feet and they don't shape, they don't cut their toenails because they're lazy fucks. That's what I end up with. I end up with ladies that just don't even give a shit. You know, they're like, you can shave it if you want. And I just sit there and I'm like, I got a hard enough time shaving my own junk. What the hell? Before you go live on YouTube, you could always post on your Facebook. I did that on the other page. I said I can't get live, and I think people might have figured it out. Freaking gross. Oh, dear. Oh, Jesus. You got to stay groomed. Yeah. If I had a girlfriend and she doesn't want to shave, then I'll be like, you can take my Remington and just touch it up or whatever the hell you want to do in there. I don't know. I don't even know. Half the time, I just want to roll over and go to bed. I'm too tired to deal with women's dilemmas. What are these little things down here? Oh, watch this. Oh, I look like Bubbles Channel number 5. Ooh. Grog, find me. That's what it's going to look like when I get beamed up in Grog's spaceship. I'm going to go to Reticula. Glamour? No, that's not glamorous. 8mm. I don't think it looks like anything. These are like filters I'm using, I think. Sepia. Silver screen. I look like an old... I look like I'm in the old... Oh, look. We could do... Oh, C. Marie needs this for her channel. With the orbs? When she's live? Oh, let me shut the light off. Wait a minute. You might see some orbs. Oh, shit. What happened to me? What happened? Wait a minute. Let me get back to that. Can you guys see anything? I asked C. Marie how she captures her EVPs, most of her EVPs and her orbs, she just turns the light on, her flash on her fucking camera. Lois, I love you. I don't know where you are right now, but I love you. You just waved at me on a message. Hunt. Ooh. I want to go to C. Marie's farm. Even her voice. She sounds like she's 13, but it's all right. As long as Chris Hansen doesn't come in, I'm good. I want to go to C. Marie's. I'm mailing her all of my ghost hunting equipment. I shit you not, C. Marie. Where the fuck are you? Oh, look, it's a sketch. Hold on. I'll show you guys some of the stuff I've got. I'm going to show you what I'm going to send C. Marie. Let me get back to normal. I'm sending C. Marie this. I'm sending her this. My static night vision camera. Right now it's set to see my cats come in, but then the landlord said you can't let the cats out. So there's no cats out. There's no need for me to have the security camera up there and watch it 24/7. So I'm going to send her, that is a static night vision camera. You aim it in the house towards your bed. You shut the lights off, you hook it up to record, and then the next day you watch it and you see your blankets move and you see your orbs and you see all your shit. So that's going to C. Marie. I think C. Marie thinks that maybe I'm not going to, I think she thinks I want her address to be, like, creepy or something like that, but that's not what it is. Hold on, I'm going to show you the rest of this crap. Hold on. I told you I'm giving away everything I have. I'm cleaning my hoarding complex. Check it out. I'm cleaning my whole hoarding complex. I've got right here, I even use this all the time. This is what you call a ghost box. This one has a built-in mic. So watch this. We'll do it. I'll show you. You turn it on. They don't make Radio Shack shit anymore, by the way. They close like most of the Radio Shacks down. But you take this. You take buy a Radio Shack radio. I think it's 12-587. And you buy one of these. You can probably buy it on eBay. Buy one of these. Then you go on YouTube and type in Radio Shack Hack. You type in the model number. You take the whole thing apart, you cut a couple things, and basically you turn it into a ghost box. So you turn it on, and then you take, I do AM, then you, what it does when you hack it, it scans the channel, so it does this. Then, Hear that? What's my name? Oh, wait, wait. Really, really low. A second ago, I could have heard really, really low. Somebody said, Chris. Creepy or not, I got goosebumps, but this is the best ghost box that I have. I listen to it. It's actually radio, too, so I listen to this in my bed, but I'm going to send this to C. Marie. I'm just going to get another tiny boombox or something to listen to the radio, but because you can't Shack Hack any other radio except for the Radio Shack Hack, the Radio Shack. So I've got another little Iowa boombox I'm perfectly good with, an old-school boombox. But anyway, this is a parabolic mic. You point it where you want to pick up on certain voices. It usually has a little thing, but I don't know what I did with the... you know how you put the little cone on the dog's head? Well, that's basically what it needs. It has a little cone around it, and it kind of aims towards it. You can probably make your own out of cardboard or something, but parabolic mic... You point it your way, and then you press it, and then you put headphones on. It plugs into the, where is it? Right here. Plugs into the headphones, or you can plug it into whatever you want recording. So there's that. I've got a brand new Radio Shack hacked. Brand new. It's all hacked, ready to go, in the box. I've also got the ghost meter. I keep all my little random papers. Hold on, I'll show you. There's an old Radio Shack hack from way back in the day. Here in Canada, all the Radio Shacks are now called The Source. They closed mine in my town. That looks like your outside. It is my outside camera, but it is a static night vision camera, which means you don't need any light. And C. Marie, when she sleeps, she can set this up to, you know, record her son's bedroom or whatever she wants to do. I don't think she really thinks that I'm sending this shit to her, but I am. She just won't give me her fucking address. Here is a digital thermometer. You point it, you know, whatever way, and you detect variations in coldness and hotness. The other day, she was in her fucking bedroom, blowing. She had her heat on, and you could see the breath in her fucking... Go watch C. Marie's videos. I talked to her. I love... absolutely fucking love C. Marie. You know, and she, and you know, she's not a hater or a bully. She does shit. She does do jokes about people, but it's in all good taste. And at the end of the day, she would, if she hurt somebody so much, she hurt their feelings that she really felt like she made them cry or, you know, really, really hurt them like that. I know that she would fucking apologize. She's anything that I've ever seen her done is never done, to purposely hurt somebody, you know, to make them cry or hurt their feelings or anything. I love what she does. It's fucking hilarious. So I've got some other shit in here. I've got just random crazy testing things. Hold on. I've got, let's see. If she wants to ghost hunt and you put this shit on your own, you put your phone in here and then you can do whatever the fuck you want. You can walk around and hold different things. This is an old school digital voice recorder where you put the little tape in it. Remember, you take the little... you know, these stupid little tapes. You take the little tape and you put it in there. And that way, there's your fucking evidence. I like old school shit like this. I love old technology. I'm not really into the new. Although I did spend $45 for this shit. This bullshit. It is stuck on track 66. This digital voice recorder. Here we go. Also, white noise generator. I don't know if you can see that. Because let me get rid of the comments. There we go. A white noise generator. We've got this. This detects electromagnetic fields. It always goes off when it hits me because I'm weird. Wait till 2 in the morning. This goes crazy. Things, I think, attach themselves to me. This is supposed to only be when you have something like this, like a cord for power or something. Your ghost got you. Yeah, I'm not even. I'm not touching anything. It's weird, yeah. So this is a electromagnetic field. Oh, you remember the couch. That's hilarious. It's funny that you guys actually do pay attention. What I got for C. Marie, she said she saged her house a few times already. But it's in the box, so she might as well just... Why not? So anyway, here's some sage. Here is, let's see what we got here. What the fuck is this? We've got, I know, right? Hold on. Got some more blank tapes for her. She loves Shakira. So I got a little Shakira keychain. I am spreading the wealth. I know C. Marie would love that shit. Somebody tell, will you tell her to come watch my video? I love her. I'm telling you, if she weren't married, I'd be all in that. I would be in that farmhouse. I'm crazy enough to want to sleep there, but not actually sleep. I'd get no sleep. I'd have bags under my eyes. I'd be ghost hunting 24/7. I would call every paranormal place on the earth. I got some holy water just in case she wants to. It comes from Boston, so it's all set. It's good. It's Boston holy water. You're good to go. You just sign of Christ, and you get your... Where's my Bible? Maybe I should send her one. Maybe I should send her one of these. What else do we have? The order forms for more holy water. I don't know. A random flashlight. So you never know when you're going to need one of these things to hook to something. What else? Some things, some plugs. Let me see what I'm forgetting. I don't know. Random batteries, plugs, just stuff. So that's it. That's the box for C. Marie. Things like but it is actually a static night vision camera. I don't know why it doesn't say that on there, but yeah. When I search for it, that's what popped up. So that's that. So somebody tell C. Marie that I'm not shitting her. I'm really sending her this shit, but she refuses to send me her address. She thinks that I'm like, I don't know what she thinks. It's just a box of crap, you know? But if I'm not using it, why not send it to her? She's the one. She gets ghosts all the friggin' time. So why not? You know what I mean? I'm not a crazy person. I keep my word, and I'm not a crazy person. Unless you really piss me off. I mean, that's the only way I don't keep my word. And if I have something and I'm not using it, I'm going to give it to the people that fucking need it. So there we go. So that's one more thing that, I'm not sure what I want to do with these slippers yet, though. I haven't, maybe I'll wear them in the summertime, you know, scooting outside just so the bottom of my feet don't get dirty or something. Wait, I lost the comments. Show live chat. She's going to love that stuff. I know, right? I ain't afraid of no ghost. Well, she doesn't deserve it if she can't give her Well, no, she wants... Well, what she keeps saying is, tell me how much money you want for this crap. And I was like, I don't want any money, C. Marie. All I want is for you to use it. And there's nobody better on this planet that can use it than her. So I want to see her use the shit. I'm not using it. It's sitting in a box. How often do you see me do the ghost box? I'll do it. I usually do this at 2 in the morning. We'll do it again, though. Let's see if it says anything. Ready? We're going to scan. Let's ask a question. Who's here? Hey. Did that stop? It stopped on 11:20. Hold on. Hey. What's my name? Oh. Did you hear that again? I heard two guys say something and it sounded like Chris. She is under C. Marie Ghost TV. Yeah, she's got the channel that she talks about. See, I don't have cable, so I don't know about these people that she talks about. I'm clueless. I'm not really with it, but I don't really watch that channel a lot. I was watching it for the Maria things because, you know, she decorated the pumpkin and she did her Maria thing, and then she got a strike. Now, what kind of an asshole is gonna really go and complain about her? Why? I don't think the haters... Sorry, my ears are blocked. I don't think the haters... This one's really, really bad. I really don't think the haters realize that when they go and come... Like, they report somebody or give them a strike or whatever, they don't realize that then they're not going to be able to keep watching her for the next 30 days. So they're just hurting themselves by missing out on her. I don't understand why people do it. It's stupid. This shirt does totally not fit me. It looks like it's not even clean. It is. I just put it on before this. If you watch the video before this, you'll see me getting out of the shower, but I couldn't go live. I was going to go live from the bathtub. Beautiful full moon here tonight. It is awesome. Earlier I showed you guys, it's all cloudy and creepy and almost Halloweenish. 3 days after Halloween. I cut myself last night. It's really, really driving me crazy. I can't seem to make it seal. Ta-da. All right, I guess I'm going to go because I'm boring. Getting ready to go dancing. What do you mean, like at a bar? What kind of dancing are you going to do, lady? Dirty dancing? Dancing in front of your kitchen sink? What are you going to do? What do you mean dancing? Going to do some leg kicks? I need more leg kicks and more cowbell. That's what I want to do if I visit Marie. I want to bring a cowbell and I want to doot, 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 doot and have her kick, 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 kick. I can kiss it and make it better. Oh, my God, no. No, listen, you haven't paid attention. I'm engaged. I can't do that. I can't flirt anymore or anything. I have to be nice and I have to be respectful to everybody. It's killing me, but all right. I'm going to the club with a couple of girlfriends. I hope you get the D, Angela. I want to be, by the way, I want to be schmooled in. What's the word? Not schmooled in. I want to be, I can't think of the S word. I want to be, not schmegma. I want to be schmerched in. What's the word? I hoping to, la 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 ba. Well, you know, you need to get in the car, get off that island, screeched in. That's it. I want to be screeched in. Screechingly. I want to be screeched in. So how do I get, I got to take a shot of the drink. That's what I was getting when I just dropped my lid from my beer. I want to drink no, that's all right. I just can't, Stephanie, no, you're good. I just can't joke around anymore and be like, hey, inviting all these ladies to my house. You know what I mean? I mean, I can invite friends to come over, but I can't be having any booty call anymore. You know what I mean? Any 2 a.m., whatever the hell I want. Cheers, cheers, everybody out there. Angela, so what do you do when you do the screech? You take a drink, then you say the thing about the cock, and then you kiss the fish, right? I'll kiss my sock monkey slippers. They're so flat. They must be nice when I stick my feet in, though. That's right. This is so warm and old. It's before my damn shower. Cheers. I'm glad you ladies found me here because I hate it when I can't go live and I want to go live and I don't really always want to go live. I'll send you another video which shows on how really do the screeching in here in Newfoundland. It's more detailed than the Conan O'Brien clip. Need a fresh one. I do need a fresh one. What I need is some Fireball, and I don't have it. It's just not going to happen for me for a while. You know the best pillows, by the way? These guys. Go to Kmart and buy these Joe Boxers. Get them on sale. They're like 2 for $5. Even if it's not on sale, $5 for one. I bought some pillows from Walmart. They suck. I love it when it's flat and it's just not all puffy. And I love flat pillows for some reason because you can put your hand underneath it and not get squished. Hold on, I'm going to burp in your face. Excuse me. Yes, the best. I can't wait to send Maria that matching hat. Thanks, Deb is me. Deb is me. I know who you are. You're Debbie Schwick. If I'm right, I hope I'm right, because you're on the list. You're number 33. You got a black leather couch, right? Me too. The fat ones give me a creak in my neck. I got 8 pillows on my bed. I went to, where the hell is it called? I went to Kmart. I spent $30 on one damn pillow. And what's the name of it? Let's see if I can find it here. No, I don't. Look, you can't even see all the feathers. It's just, you can't. I'm not even going to open that up. Look at all the fucking... Sorry, my air purifier is getting them towards that way. I've got fluffy, feathery ones, but they're not my favorite. By the way, only an hour away. Well, you need to come over here then, and we need to have a drink. We don't have to sit in the house. We can go places and do stuff. We can go to the beach. We can we can play some skee ball if it's on the weekend. There's always something to do when you're around me, whether it's a bonfire or a beach or whatever. Usually if you let me know a day ahead of time, I can plan something fun. I have a memory foam pillow with a hump for the neck. I have one of those. Well, actually, my ex-wife is think it's in the other room. I don't want to touch it, though. I don't want to touch anything she touched. That's why I don't sleep in that damn bed. The guests can sleep in that thing. I'm not... Not having that. I just assume burn the fucking thing. If I had a new bed, I would burn it. Not to be hostile or anything, just to be like, screw it. Screw it! Look at my hair. It's so sweaty. Yeah, I bought a Sleep Number pillow. I made a YouTube video about it, and Sleep Number tried to contact me, and I was like, fuck you. I don't care. Your pillow sucks. The Sleep Number pillow smells like some rotten chemical from Fukushima. I hated that damn pillow. Let me see what my friend's mom wrote. Bonfire night, Guy Fawkes night. What is Guy? Hold on. Oh my God. This is my friend's mom. Are you going to marry my daughter? Please let me know. Oh my God. Yep. I don't know if she told her mom the great news, but now her mom is messaging me. I don't know why her mom unfriended me on Facebook. That's a little creepy. And yesterday it said who I was engaged to, but then today I wake up and it just says nothing. Maybe she took it off. Maybe she was embarrassed. I'd be embarrassed if I was with me too. I wouldn't want to tell too many people. I'd want to keep it on the down low. I think it would be like more like a joke between my friends and shit. I think that's what women do. Can we meet your fiance? I don't think she... I'm like, I don't understand what she's doing today. I got 13... I have 8. I have 1. Let's count them. 1, 2. Okay. 3. That's brown. 4. Hold on a second. 5. 6. I'm not shitting you. 7. Hold on. Get the very last one here. 8. There we go. Here is the Chris Dilemma of pillows. 8 motherfuckers. Ah. 8 pillows. Yes. How many pillows do you have? And it's just me. And I still can't get fucking comfortable. When I get home, I will send a pic. Chris, awesome. Stop. I'm happy for you. I'm happy. That's not a dot. It's an M. Wait. He has a drink every year on November 5th. There's a story behind Guy Fawkes. Stephanie, I've missed you. Get back on Facebook. Make up a fake fucking name. All right? If you want, I'll give you a fake. I'll open up a fake account. And I'll give it to you just so you can be on there and just watch me. You don't even have to comment. And it was rotten for the people that were, you're not the only one, by the way. Remember when that happened and you were telling me how you felt and how you really felt shitty that time and, you know, and you were putting your feelings on the line? You're not the only one that feels like that. You know how many messages I get in my message box if I sat there and read them all? I try to read them all and it's everybody, please talk to me. I need someone to talk to. And messages like that, yes, I talk to. And I get kind of consumed with those. Either I'm in my message box for the day, messaging people, getting on Facebook, or I have to kind of get away from it because it can consume my whole freaking day. I will go back on in Stephanie after and look under the comments. Like 3 people jumped her. You remember that, Melanie? It was more than that. It was like 7 people and they were really bothering her. And all she had said was she feels like killing herself. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. She kind of said something like that, and people had said, you know, rotten shit to her. They had said the cruelest things to her, and I had thought, you know, and I feel like that sometimes. I've gone on Facebook and said, you know what? The bullies have fucking won. They've made me feel like jumping off a bridge. I'm not even lying. I've felt like that. I've got like that, You know, people were rotten and saying stuff, and it's sad that you had to get off Facebook, you shouldn't have to get off Facebook. You know, you should just next time you encounter some asshole like that, automatically, that's what I was doing on my page too. Automatically, just block it. Don't waste your time or energy even responding to it, 'cause they fucking love it. So I just yesterday I unblocked everybody on the page. I figured, you know what? Sometimes maybe somebody said something and they didn't mean it. So I figured I'll give them all a fucking second chance. Some of them were on accident that I blocked them. I had to. They hurt me so bad. But you know, I'm learning now just to block it. Block the person. If they say something rude, don't think twice and think, what are you going to say to them? How are you going to, you know, react? Don't even bother. Just fucking block it. Just be like, you know what? Fuck off. If you don't do that, I mean, if I took every insult that I have and I commented back to every little insult, that's so time consuming. There are so many people out there that give me rotten comments and stuff and messages. Boom, block, boom, block. Why bother wasting my precious time on that crap just to tell them, well, you know, you're a fucking asshole or grow up or something. They feed off of it. You know, once I take my energy to comment back, then they comment back something even worse. And it's like, I should have never fucking said anything in the first place. I should have just ignored it. And I know it's hard to ignore. I love to take something. If Maria has a rotten day and she's mean to me, I love to take it and show everybody how rotten she is and say, look at this now. It's unbelievable. But I think it makes you look like a better person if you just take that shit that somebody says and sweep it under the rug and just think, you know what, I'm going to say a little prayer for them. Maybe they're having a bad day. Maybe they're going through something. Maybe they're not always like this. And maybe tomorrow they'll be a little bit of a better person. That's all you can fucking hope for is to try to hope, you know, say a little prayer for them. That's what I do. I will stick up for you in a heartbeat. Yeah, I don't want a girlfriend that sweeps me under the rug. Today I woke up and it said my engagement, whatever, no name on there. And I said to myself, wait a minute, what the fuck is this shit? I don't know, it kind of made me think, well, you know, I'm like, what is this girl afraid? I don't understand that. That's not what I want. I want somebody that's proud to be with me, that sticks up for me, and doesn't, you know, push me under the rug. But if that's all right, you know, whatever. I'll meet the right girl. I'm not even actually, you know, like, I'm really not looking. I'm totally, like, happy by myself, just fucking being me, drinking a couple beers here and there, chatting with everybody, and just doing my own thing. I'm not, you know what I mean? I don't have any, I don't really care. I'm still going through 2 years in divorce court, so the last thing I really want to do is get married. That's just not even on my bucket list. It's not something that I want to do. It's a headache when you get married. That's all it is when you get divorced. A giant freaking headache. I'm sorry, I'm going through my mail trying to get a drink. Do I want a fruit to owe? Do I want a beer? You gimmed when you're not looking. You find when you're not looking. Yeah, I'm not even really looking. For the other day, I got mad at this girl that I liked, and I went on there and I put a marriage proposal thing on there, and it was funny, and then nobody had really commented, and then somebody had commented, and it, you know, it was like fun and stuff. But I don't know, you know, I don't know. I fell in love with somebody that has a terminal illness. And so that's basically where my heart is. I've never made it a secret to anybody. But you know, obviously you can't be with somebody if they're terminally ill because they're going to die on you. So that's why we're not together, because eventually what's going to happen, the inevitable. So I guess they wouldn't be with me to save me my feelings or something like that. I don't know the exact quote, but here we go. Cheers. So, I mean, that's really where my heart was for a long time, was just thinking, you know, I'm going to have to watch this person die. Netflix and sleep. Yes, Melanie, were you going to start watching Riverdale with me? I'm not watching Riverdale alone, I'll tell you that. Either you're going to watch it with me or not. I'm not going to watch it, though. I'll keep watching. I finished The Mist the other day. That was pretty good. Kind of mad. Yeah, Deb, it you know, it's not a when you know, I started having feelings for her, it wasn't like that. I don't know, it wasn't a terminal, she wasn't terminally ill, it was, she was just sick, you know, and she got sicker and sicker and sicker, and then one thing led to another, so I don't know. We're friends, bottom line, and that's where a lot of my attention goes. So sometimes you guys wonder, Chris, you haven't been on in days and days, and you haven't updated who won this contest or that. And it's I try to divide my time between my, like, me having my me time. Right now, it's the weekend. I need a little bit of me time. She went to the doctor. She's going home to eat. She's spending time with her mom. So this is like my me time. I can do whatever the hell I want. And then it's just hard. Sometimes you guys wonder, where have you been? What are you doing? I spend a lot of time. You know, you can't, you know, once somebody's gone, you can't get, you know, you only have so long to make memories. And so when someone's gone, I try to do the best I can. But lately her mood has just been, it's hard to want to be around somebody who kind of makes me feel like shit. Not that she means to, but she's just not in a good mood. So I kind of try to stay away a little bit. Because I don't like my spirits getting down in all the dumps. You know, I don't want to be down in the dumps all the time. I'm trying to read your comments, but they keep going away. I have, by the way, I need to do this. I need to go down the list of who the hell won. I've got 35, 34 people on this list. And I don't know, you know, some people might not want their name out there. They might not want their name on YouTube or whatever. But I think I might. I might make it under a note, maybe under the other page, or under, if I can do a something. You have a fire in your soul and a lot of love in your heart. I don't know. Why are these comments? They go, and then when I want to go read it, show live chat messages. I wish there was more people in the world like you. That's where your focus should be. When someone is sick, you have to, I have to realize that if I was in her shoes, I would probably be biting people's heads off too and not, it's not fair. And I would be probably angry. Yeah. But for me to try to every day, every morning, wake up and think, okay, forget about what happened yesterday. Let's just start a new day, you know? Zorg thinks Chris, oh my God, Zorg, come get me. Zorg, I'm ready. I'm here. I'm ready for you. Zorg, please, come get me. Zorg, please, I'm ready. There's a field across the street. I know you've been here before. Go on Wikipedia, type in Betty and Bonnie Hill, or type in incident at Exeter, E-X-E-T-E-R. You've been in this field before, Zorg. I know about your probe. You got to come land in the field. You've been here twice. You've been here. I know what your spaceship looks like. It's triangle and it's got the orange lights on all the sides, three of them. You need to land right there in this field, Zorg. Please, come get me. I'm coming in your ship. I'm ready. I'm coming and I'm not telling anybody after this happens. That's it. You'll see me and one day I'll be disappeared and I'll be on your ship, Zorg. I'm staying away from negative people, but I'm coming. I'm on your ship. I got us matching hats, Zorg. Watch this. Hold on, Zorg. Don't go nowhere. I got us hats. You're gonna love it. You better let me. You better come get me. I'm freaking ready for this shit. I'm not playing, Zorg. If you don't come get me, I'm gonna be disappointed. Hold on. Wait a minute. I got it. Here we go, Zorg. Look, me and you. Are you ready? This is mine because I like yellow. When you come get me, I'm going to come into the spaceship wearing this hat. It's got all... Look at... Do you see your home planet? Do you see your star system on here? Wait a minute, Zorg. Zorg, hide all the mess. Do you see your home star system? Do you see? There you... It's probably in the red. Zorg, I'm here and I got one for you. Look, we're matching. It's your system, right? I know where you are. You're there. Come get me. This will be the ideal time during the full moon. You don't even need to turn your lights on in the field. You just land, boom. I'll see you over there. I watch that field all the time. All you got to do, maybe shine a little flashlight over here, and I'll be running over there. I'm coming. I won't even bring my cats. You don't want cats on your ship, do you? Nobody wants to change the litter box, right? I'm ready. I got you a hat, Zorg. I'm ready. We're going to be friends. This is it. I'm ready. Unless you got, you know, better friends than me. I'm sitting here. I'm waiting. I'm waiting. You need to, you've been here before, and I know it, and you know it. I know you've been here. Everybody knows it. The other day, they even had it on the news. Yeah, I think they seen a little bit of your ship. You need to come here, and we're going to be friends, and that's it. I'm ready. I don't have any, you don't have any issues when I hug you, because I've never hugged an alien, but I'm thinking you might be kind of warm. Are you warm? Are you cold? Are you gray? What do you look like? I'm dying. I don't even care what you look like. It's probably better than any of my exes. Screw it. Where are all the chat messages? Zorg, where are you? I dropped Maria on her head. So I have to redo experiment. Listen, pick me up first. I'll help you hold her down. I'll hold her legs for you so she don't kick too much. Warm and gray. Oh, good. I'm thinking you're pretty warm and maybe almost like fuzzy. I hope this fits your head. It might be a little, you might need a bigger size. You know, I don't know. I don't know if you have a big head or a little head. You probably have amazing eyes. I'm an eye person. I fall in love with eyes. Fun. Fun. I'm waiting. I can't wait. I'm waiting. I know you've been here. Every year we have this festival hoping you come back. Type it in. Exeter fucking Alien Festival. Exeter, New Hampshire. E-X-E-T-E-R. Type it in. Alien Festival. We look for you every August or September. We have this festival and we go, we stare and we're like, where are you? No probe in the butt. Hey, you can probe my butt. You can go probe. You can probe my ass. I don't care. I'm ready. I'm ready for the heat probe. I'll even let your friend do it. I'll even let your friend join in probing me. I don't care. I'm ready. Take me off of this place. I'm done. I don't want no more Trump. You guys have a president in your home planet? I don't think you do. Probably don't have anything really much. You have black people out there because you're gray. You probably have all kinds of people that you've taken already up there. Weirdos. People like strange men that are like in their 30s drinking beer in South Dakota. No butt for me, can't. Oh, shit. I forgot about that. Cheers. No, I have a boss, Grog. No, Grog's the one I'm in love with. Grog's the one I'm waiting for. You're Zorg. Oh, shit. I'm ready. I will tell you how bad I want to go to Zeta Reticuli. I won't even wear my bear suit. I'm ready. I'll go in there naked. I'll just be here. Naked. I'll be, whatever, however you want me. I'll be naked or clothed, whatever you want. You can do all kinds of experiments. Do you guys have beer? Do I need to bring my own 30 rack? I'll bring my cooler with the wheels. I'll bring it. You guys, listen, just shine a light. You got go to Dollar Tree and get a light like this. I'll see it from a mile away. You go in that field and you shine. Make that little humming noise that you guys did before. I know I heard you before and I wasn't having any hallucinations. I want to know how it goes. I have a funny feeling when they take me, they're not going to bring me back. And listen, I'm probably going to have to bring my own chapstick. I'm really anal retentive. I should probably put that in my bag. I'm starting to get my bag ready. If you see me with my mace, know that I'm not going to attack you. I don't know what I'm going to encounter on this trip. So I need to get all my shit. I need my ducks in a row. It's that time of the year when you have your chapstick. Just, you got to have it everywhere. All right, what's going on here? I hate these. Why do the messages go away? We don't drink beer, so bring your own. You don't drink beer. Well, you need to start doing some. Can I bring Fireball? Am I allowed to bring Fireball? I don't even know. You don't have a president, do you? This is amazing. I'm ready. I guess I gotta get Zorg and Grog a hat. That's, you know what that means. One more trip to the beach where you get the cheap sunglasses. Where do these messages, why do they keep flying away? Yes, chapstick, I use it every time. My favorite is the pomegranate gumdrop. What do you drink, Zorg? I don't know, but I'm ready. I've been ready for this for months now. Does anyone know if he can read his chat messages after he is done streaming? I just got on. Where are you going? I'm going to Zeta Reticuli. I guess apparently it's a star system light years away. Who knows? I don't care. I'm bringing chapstick. I'm bringing some friggin', probably a couple Percocets. Sure, bring that and your wacky tobacco if you want. Oh, I'm going to bring some stuff then. I'll hook us up with some Adderalls, some Percocets, whatever I can find. You know, weed is legal now in America, right? So, like, pretty much. Do you have rules in space? Anyway, you probably don't have any type of rules. When live is over, nope, can't read them. Miley Percocets? I'm bringing everything. Bring some. I've never done Molly. What the hell? I've heard that that's a wild ride. They closed down President Trump's Twitter account today. He tweets too much. He's supposed to be working. Shit, cut the fucking golf shit, first of all. The no golf. That can't be a thing. No golf for Trump. Remember how President Obama used to go away to Martha's Vineyard once in a while with his family and it was beautiful and they bring the fucking dog and shit? What is this? Trump is always golfing. Tweeting, he's on Twitter more than me. Come on, don't you have a fucking job to do? Like, what is he doing? North Korea is ready to bomb the shit out of us. And here's Trump, playing with my ass today, cutting my ass. Hey, by the way, ladies, how do you guys shave your ass hairs? Now, don't tell me you don't have any between your cheeks when you get way up to the top. No need for rules. Only thing is not dropping specimens on their head. I'm always dropping. Oh, shit. Yeah, I think I might have been dropped a while ago. You guys might have picked me up and tested me. You took me through my skylight and you tested me through my belly button. I've been telling this for years. I'm not even going to lie. I get teary-eyed about thinking about it. But yeah, I might have got dropped too. I don't know. It wasn't a good thing. When I went back home, I was different. And my belly button hasn't been the same either. You tell me. How do you guys do your testing? It's not like the one-touch test strips. Razor. No. So I'm here. You have to shave all the... Well, I don't understand this now. I've never had hair like this growing like that. Like, so frequently or whatever. Like, maybe once or twice a year you just find a random hair. But now I'm noticing all this hair. And I'm, like, wondering what the hell... How... What, why? Is there a thing that you can buy, like, a special thing? I don't even know. I've been using my little Remington. There's a little nose hair clipper thing that's got three little prongs on it. And you just zoom, 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 zoom. All I want to do is zoom, 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 then a boom, boom. Italian, too. You're French and Italian. Everybody, Stephanie's hairy. We all need to know this. We all need to know you need a razor and soap. Your belly button cannot be the stranger. Cannot be stranger than the rock and demo. Do it when you're... I don't understand that. I think she's got a belly button ring there, but I think it's one of the big ones. Melanie would know because she's, not Stephanie. Melanie would know because she's at the tattoo parlor. I think what Rockin' Demo has is the biggest little curved belly button ring with a little ball on one end and then a giant crazy little ball on the other that has something in it. It could be like, it could say love or some crap like that. But yeah, she's got a weird belly button. I've seen that. I don't understand it. I would love to experiment, like, go up to it and see it and look at it closer up. She never gets close enough to the camera for me to see that stuff, you know? Like, you can see my nose hairs probably right now or something. Yeah, finally, I'm back. Shitty connection. A banana bar with a tea dangly. Yeah, it's kind of like this, curved like that. Like a banana, yeah, you're right. Here's Chris's banana. It's not looking that good. It looks like roadkill. I love coconut soap. Where is this conversation going? I use a razor with a movable head. My head kind of, it pivots, I guess. It's a pivoting head, ladies and gentlemen. Lolly la. Holly, I know who you are. Are you on the list? I'm pretty sure you are, because you're always on something. Are you not on the list? You have to be on the list. I can't believe you're not on the list. Holly are there every freaking day. Why? Nope. Can't find you. I don't know why you're not on the Pearl Party list. That's strange. You should be, because you're here, like, all the friggin' time. Every day I see you, and I'm dropping my crap. I'm gonna bring a bunch of shit in that spaceship when they come get me. They can drop me, even on purpose. I don't care. Make it part of their testing. If I had a mustache, it'd be like this. Hey, ladies, what's up tonight? Mustache ride. Mustache rides for everybody. There's my tongue ring. It's got it's got a pointer on there. It's got a pointer on there, so I know when I'm hitting the spots that I need to hit on a Friday night. Getting it all silky and sweet up in that. It's all juicy. Ugh. What? Hold on. Now I look like a pedophile. Hey guys, what's going on? I'm the pedophile that lives down the street. Whatever happened to Wilfred Brimley? This smells like smoke. Can't remember where I was when I had this. I'm ready. Beam me up. Alright, you guys are boring. No one's talking to me. Why? Let's have some beer. It's cold and everybody loves it. Hold on. Hey, is there anything good to watch on Netflix? A couple of you said Riverdale. If I can talk Melanie into it, that's what we're going to watch. Hey, Holly. Okay, Roughline, sweetie. I'm going to going. Love you. Take care, buddy. Because you went offline. I'm here. I'm not going anywhere. I don't know why it stopped. Zorg, what's going on tonight? I hope you guys got strippers up in that fucking spaceship. Stripping. That's where we should, once you pick me up, I'll take you to the strip joints and show you where to beam down and who to get. I'll even show you where a couple strippers live on Vine Street. Stranger Things is what I'm watching. Is it good? I think Stranger Things is from Stephen King. I just got done watching The Mist. It was really weird, creepy, good, but it's only season one, and how long can you drag it out? I don't know. It got dragged out pretty long. I thought it would end. Are you guys really serious? Stranger Thing? Maybe I need to watch that instead of Riverdale. I was just going to watch... Why is my... Do you ever notice my light just shuts the hell off for some reason? Because I have a succubus. Not like C. Marie. I've got a succubus. She's evil. She holds me down at night. Yep. Strippers are fine as long as they aren't skinny. No, they're not skinny. These ones have some thighs. Meat on their bones. Oh, I did it yesterday. Wait a minute. Let's do it again. Let's see if we can do this. I pulled out my back, so since it's already screwed up and I'm taking some Kratom today, might as well show you again. I've been practicing on my dance moves. Hell yeah. Watch this shit. Watch this. Here comes Bandit again. He's on my chair. He's going for a freaking ride. Hi. What's going on? Oh, hi, Patch. Hi. You want to go up in a spaceship? Oh, hi, Grandpa. Hi, Grandpa. You're so... Oh, yes. Oh, not my, He won't move. I can't get my groove on like I did last night. I've been practicing. I know what Maria... I watched it. You know what? I don't care if my cat's here. Hold on. Let me move my banana boat. Here we go, ladies. I'm getting my old friggin' ass up here. Look, hey, I got new boxes on today. Aren't these ones sexy? These are better Magic Mics than yesterday, right? Woo! Oh yeah. Forget about the no pants. Just forget that. Forget I even had pants on. Watch. This is what she does. I can't do the leg kick. Wait a minute. Hold on. Let me get it up. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Let me get my saggy pants on this. All right, here we go. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Wrong way. Let's get this thing. We're back. Here we are. Look. I'm learning. I'm dry humping. I'm doing it. I learned. It's this. And then it's that. It's that. And it's this. And then it's, I'm going to fall. She gets to have that arm out when she does it. Like, just like this. It's a roundhouse kick, ladies. I need to work on this. Perfecting my grind. Am I doing it right? Tell me. Tell me what you need me to do. And I want her to do some nipple twists. That's what she needs in her dances. She turns and rubs her butt. Yes, I'm going to watch Stranger Things. Strippers are fine. Hold on, I'm going to rub my butt. Where are we? We're moving around here. Do I have a big butt? Probably. I bet you it looks a lot better like this, though. Hold on, wait a minute. Now you can see my tiny ass. Look how little it is. That's kind of cute. It doesn't look good, though, I don't think. Anyway. Am I doing it? I think it's better when you have your pants down, right? Is it not sexier when you have your pants down? I don't know. I don't friggin' know. Over 2 years and she still can't dance. No, I don't understand. I started doing some moves yesterday, just a little something something. I don't even know. But yeah, I can't. It's something like this that she did. Let me get this one. It's like the wiggly arms. Wait, now my crotch is down to my knees. I look like, oh, there's a camel toe. It's Chris's camel toe. All right, here we go. Wait a minute. I'm going to maneuver my junk. That's it. That's what I want to do. I watched it last night. I watched it and I thought, oh, I'm going to try to do this. Yes, and she does same on her butt. I got to get the music. Hold on, I'll fucking... Let's get some music on this baby. She does the same... She rubs her butt like that? I went and I thought, you know what? I'm going to try to perfect it. Hold on. Here we go. The guys will love this part. Hold on. One for the road. Hold on. I can't put it in there. There we go. Watch this. Watch this. Oh, I don't want to eat it. It's got a blind spot. It would look like I'm a deep throater, but what? Look at that. For the road. Love this tune for real. I love Canada. You Canadian ladies are amazing. Why do I have hair on my face? Because of the mustache? Imagine if this whole banana was in my throat. Let's try to make a dirty screenshot. We can use it on all the memes. Ready? The whole thing in my mouth. Imagine if this was all in my mouth. Come on, take your screenshots. I know what you guys are doing. You're taking your screenshots and then you're gonna make your memes. Chris's banana. Oh my god, you bright my sometimes shit eyes. What? Listen, I'm gonna sweep my house. Listen, do you hear that? No toys for tots coming there. What was she sweeping that day? Please tell me. I'm sweeping. You guys hear any dirt? Nothing. I don't get it. You guys know what I'm talking about. Tell me what she was sweeping. I'm dying. No, there are so many questions I would love if I visited her to ask the answers to all my questions. I'm going to buy her a new pot holder, too. That's just going to happen. I'm eating a banana. I know, it's so fucking rude. I was talking with my mother, but you want to see my salt lamp? Hold on. I'll take you in my lovely guest bedroom. Oh, there we go. Wait a minute. Where are we? What is in the way? Oh, my hand. There we go. There's my salt lamp over there. Uber Goober girl got me it. Why am I stuttering? Uber. U-B-E-R. Uber Goober girl. She got me my salt lamp. She's amazing. People mail me things. I don't know why it happens. I've got feathers all over me from that damn pillow. All right, I guess I'm going to go finish my banana. Oh, yeah. So good. But this banana is all kind of weird black and blue and spots and shit. Gross. All right, ladies. I hope you guys have a nice night. And to you, and you too. Zorg, tell Grog I said hi. Sorry, I'm eating with my mouth open. I'm watching my camera. In case you missed it the other day, it was 1 a.m. and some friends just decided, let's go visit Chris on a random Tuesday night. I must leave now. All right, Zorg. Have a good night. I send you some cool Canadian shit, but not Facebook friendlies. Deanna, have a good night. What's in the background? I can see your face, but it looks like something in the background. Here's my my many pillows. Now I want to take a nap after just eating a banana. My whole bed is full of stuff now. Two, I meant laughing my ass off. Nobody, it's funny that you guys, half of you guys aren't, like, nobody's Facebook friendly. You need to create fake Facebook accounts and just get the hell in there. Because it's going to be fun no matter what. I have a fun time no matter what, so. The pro party's going to be fun no matter what. Everybody's going to walk away having fun and walking away getting something. And that way they can think about me when they look at it. At a bar in the picture. Oh. I love bars. I think they're amazing. Friendlies, not friendly. Wait a minute. Where? Let me read this. I can send you some cool Canadian shit, but not Facebook friendlies. Not friendly. I don't know what you mean. I love watching you on Facebook. Jennifer, you're sexy. But I can't say that anymore. I want to be invited to the pearl party. Hannah Storm, I've never seen your name before. You gotta tell me who the fuck you are on Facebook. Right now, if you come out with your Facebook name, I'll add you just because I'm not an asshole. You're not on there. There is no Hannah Storm. I remember the names. I'm saying if we aren't friends on Facebook, I can get info. Wait. I can't get info to send you cool ass shit, lol. Vodka's kicking in. Lisa, then you go on Facebook and you type in Chris Rage. Then you look page. Don't go under people, groups, or anything. Go under the page. Find me, Lisa, on my page. And you gotta like me, add me, whatever. I don't add anybody on my personal Facebook account because I have family there. And somebody had already made jokes about my undescended testicle. So now my Uncle Norman at Christmas time will be saying something. So I don't add anybody, and I now every time I post something public, I really have to watch what I post, because If somebody comments something rude, my family sees that shit. So, but I made Hannah Storm from Maine. I'm close to Maine. I'm actually right at the border of Maine. Kittery is like a half an hour away. I'm sorry I'm blowing my nose in your face, but... oh, God, my allergies. I want to take Benadryl, but it's too early. Maybe I'll take one of those Zyrtec. Where the hell are they? In the bag, in the trash bag full of stuff. The stuff for I'm taking this tonight, I'll tell you that. Where are we? Do I want Claritin? Or what's the difference between Claritin and Zyrtec? Let's do the math. Claritin is for sneezing, runny nose, itchy, watery eyes, itchy throat or nose. Zyrtec is just nothing. Antihistamine. It's all it... wait a minute. Runny nose, sneezing, itchy, watery eyes, itching of the nose or throat. I don't know what's the better one to take. You tell me, ladies. I totally get why you do not add. I don't add friends. You know, it was a profile picture of me on a unicycle, and somebody had posted something. You know, they were making a joke, and it was all funny. We talked the other night. We talked about the story. Oh, I see. I don't know who you are on Facebook. You're not Havana Storm on Facebook. Claritin, definitely. Well, then that's what I'm going to take. Anyway, you're not... I never talked to you. Not Havana. You have a... that's what sucks is you guys have different names, you know, from Facebook and this, YouTube's. Somebody's messaging me and I don't know what it is. I'll be here all fucking day. How many autistic people does it take to screw open a thing? Deanna Gobert. Oh. Yeah, now you look... wait. No, you're not the one from Maine. This message you on your page, laughing my ass off. Why are you laughing your ass off? Please don't tell me it's something rude. Hey, Anna, what are you wearing? You got sexy black hair. Your face looks purple. You almost look like an alien, but I'm not going to be rude. Just don't take it the wrong way. You've seen me. I'm Melissa. I have. Well, you don't... there's those eggs. Those eggs in a basket. Pronounce Gobert. It's French. Message me your freaking message. Just message me. I'm taking this Claritin shit. I like it when it dissolves in your mouth like the aloe vera crap. Cheers, ladies. Gobert. Much respect. I can't stand the people that are rude. I just block them. I can't stand disrespectful people. So thank you for, you know, being nice. I can only say thank you enough. My pick on Facebook has an owl. Cheers! I talk to everybody, but for me to, like, remember who's who and what's what and what's and whose name goes with what and who's lives here and who lives there is, like, I would need, like, flowchart or something. I'm very not... I mean, I can remember what I said, but I can't remember who said what, when, and who lives where. I can't. It would be nice if I had, like, an empty map, not colored in, just in black and white, and I can write, this person's from here, this person's from here, this, and take little notes or something. So it would help me, because I look like I'm an asshole, and I don't remember half the shit. But that's not the case. I cannot breathe. It's okay. I pop in on Facebook now to wish you a blessed day. Then I know you if you're saying blessed day. Not a lot of people say that. Oh, hi, darling. Wow. Stephanie Kirkpatrick from Maine. Are you on? Wait a minute. That looks familiar. Hold on. I can't believe you're not on the list. Really? That fucking Joan A. Smith, she said she's a stalker. I'm willing to say, yeah, she's on this Pearl list 4 or 5 times. That's funny. I usually remember the name Stephanie because that's my sister's name. Uh-oh. Message. Somebody sent me a message. That was the first time with your live in that one act. Wait. That was the first time with your live that someone acted like that. With address and loving you. Wow, kind of scary. Wait, what? What do you mean? Wait a minute. With address and loving you? I don't know what she's saying. I get crazy people. Don't lie. I'm not making it up. I get crazy people. Where are you from, Holly? That you have a foot of snow. My friend that lives, where's the Brokeback Mountains? Wyoming? She moved to Colorado. She got a shitload of snow today. Where they stay, the landlord made them move their cars so he could plow, and a tree fell on them. What are the odds of that shit? Oh, Montana. Shit, North Carolina here. I didn't know what to think about you at first, but now I'm a fan, now you're a trip. I'm not a bad person. I think a lot of people misjudge me because, excuse me, I was just genuinely nice to Maria. I have no ill will. She does her own thing, and I don't wish anybody any evilness, you know what I mean? Everybody can have a good fucking day. I'm not a bad person. I'm just in my own little world, and I'm not harming anybody or, like, causing any crap, commotion, or whatever, drama. Why do these damn things, these stupid messages keep going away? I'm from Tennessee. I've met in so many... Oh, I see you. Now you message me with your owl. I love that owl. We have snowy owls here. Wait, you're straight up... Wait, let me read that. Goods, Chris. How is Maria? I don't see much anymore. Maria is doing more Facebook Live and less YouTube. And I'm kind of doing the opposite now. Tonight, Facebook Live would not work, and it really pissed me off. I'm in the bathtub, shaving my ass crack, and I thought this would be great for Facebook Live. I'm shaving my ass crack. I just put this shirt on, and it looks like I'm all dirty and sweaty, and I'm not. So anyway, I'm shaving my ass crack, and I'm trying to set up Facebook Live early, and it would not go. So it pissed me off, and I said, I'm going to go on here. And I started making a video for YouTube, and then I thought, let me try to do YouTube Live. Let me see what happens with that. Ha ha ha, bum fluff. No, I'm doing these shots, right? And lost my feed. I'm doing these shots, and what pisses me off is my hair's growing more than normal. And I'm taking biotin, so it grows in healthy and shit. But I don't get the whole... The butt hair thing is just tripping me out because it's never grown like that. Maybe once or twice a year I'll get a random hair, but now it's like, whatever. No. I'm not taking it like disrespect. I'm just laughing because I'm in the shower today with my razor thinking, how do you ladies do it? You got to go from bottom to top, and then how do you get in the crevice, though? I tried to do it sideways, but I didn't want to get cut. You know how you go sideways with a razor and you get cut? Yeah, I already got cut on my finger yesterday doing the pearls. I opened some pearls yesterday in case you missed it. See, you guys that are only on YouTube, you do miss out when you're not on Facebook because I do so much more on Facebook. It's just a lot easier on Facebook. Leg up on bathtub. Today was the first day I actually had my leg up on the bathtub. I've never done that before, and I usually just look down, and that's just it. Today, I thought, I want to get everything. I want to, you mow your lawn. Sometimes you go once or twice around with the, you know, you're driving the lawnmower so you miss something the first time. Spread them. Go easy. I had to hold one butt cheek while I kind of tried to make it flat and go sideways. But then you realize you need a significant other. You need them to come in and say, hey, can you just get this for me so I don't hurt myself? Because I'll hurt myself. I'm just not, you know what I mean? I don't want that hair growing there, but I'm like, it's kind of hard to do alone. It's very hard to do it shaving butt hair alone. I hope you guys can relate. You know, you need to call someone in and say, can you help me for a minute? Just for, like, not shave my whole thing. Just shave just what I can't get. I mean, like, you can't see behind you. There was these guys a few weeks ago. I watched videos on Facebook, and they have these videos, and they were testing this back shaver. But they were doing it, like, dry in the middle of New York City, and they were asking random people to shave their back. Have a good night. Bedtime for my sick ass. I think everybody's sick, April. Seriously, you're not the only one. I'm sick. You're sick. It's the time of the year where the weather changes. Unless you're, like, probably in Australia. Now you're having your spring if you're in Australia. It is 12 in the afternoon in Australia right now. And you guys are finally getting your spring. You had a really cold winter. It was crazy. You guys never get temperatures like that. We usually have, now it's usually cold, like 40 or 30. Well, today was 75 degrees here, so I don't know what the deal is with the whole warm air that I'm having where I live. On the coast of New Hampshire, oh, somebody else messaged me, not the owl girl. What is this? Oh, it's somebody wants, you know, I play games on Facebook, by the way. Sharon wants, she sent me a puzzle from her gallery. I gotta collect it. I play the puzzle. I play Final Fantasy. If you want to play Final Fantasy, hell, I'll add you on Facebook, even just to play Final Fantasy. I don't have anybody that plays Final Fantasy with me. I'm like level 630 getting the monster, climbing up the little snow tree thing. You guys don't know what I'm talking about. Zorg went to bed early. Zorg thinks I'm boring. I am boring. I'll hand it to you. I am boring. Tonight I'm boring. I live in Jersey. It was also... You don't live far away then. Jersey's not that far. My friend lives in near Pawtucket, Rhode Island. It's only an hour and a half away. I did not even know that. I did not know she was so close. I feel like a jerk all this time. She's going through some health issues and I should have been there, you know, to visit her and stuff. I thought she was 4 or 5 hours away, but no. Maria is 5 hours away. North, kind of like northwest. I thought Maria was southeast. No, not east, southwest. I used to play Final Fantasy on PlayStation. There's a version if you're on Facebook Messenger that you can play, and it is fun. All you got to do is tap, tap, tap with your fingers. I live 6 hours from Manchester. That's not that far. 6 hours. Jersey's a fun place. It is a fun place. Hey, whatever happened when you guys had Hurricane Sandy and your, you know how you have all the rides, what do you call it? Atlantic City, right? No, not, am I wrong? Will you guys have the shore, will you guys have all the rides and stuff? I can't think of what it's called. You have all the rides. Remember how the storm had washed away the rides and all that shit? Whatever happened to that? Did you guys rebuild that shit or no? Atlantic's, maybe I was right, Atlantic City. Did you guys rebuild that or what the hell happened? Caper Chick. You don't look like, do I know you? Do I know you? You're the, I know only a few people call me buddy. You can't be pink lips because your lips aren't pink. Oh, you are pink lips. Ah! I thought you were, but I wasn't sure. Wildwood, New Jersey. Oh, that's who you... I thought you were, but I was like, you don't have pink lips there, so like you can't be. But you're the only one that calls me buddy. Watch this. I just... I had your card right here, and I was looking at it, and I was showing everybody. You missed it earlier. And I said, look. Love you, buddy. See? Nobody calls me buddy, so right there, there we go. See, I pick up on little things, little pet names. And earlier, yes, I did show your card for my wall of doom that I'm going to put. There's your lips, pink lips. That's what more people need to do on their cards, by the way. They need to fucking put some lipstick on and kiss it. It's sealed with a kiss. Bada bing. Where are the messages? I hate this thing. It goes away. I keep losing your feet. I'm going to go. I just want to give you some love and hugs. You're such a sweetie. Aw, thank you. I believe they are in the process of still rebuilding it from... You know how long... That was 5 years ago we had Hurricane Sandy in 2012. Yep, that's me. That's you. I know who you are. I thought you were you, but I wasn't 100% sure. My nose. This Claritin better get the fuck in. Hey, in case you missed it, Pink Lips, my friend gave me a bag full of a joy today. She gave me, instead of Benadryl, it's Waldril. She gave me 70 Claritin, 70 Zyrtec. Not all of them are in there. She gave me batteries for my vibrator. It's like Christmas in November. Somebody told me to do Afrin. I don't dare to use it because it looks like it's been used. She gave me a random tape measure. I don't know why. Maybe I want to measure my junk later on. Some Neosporin. Some Clara spray. She gave me some Flonase. What else is in here? Some Aleve. She gave me like the sick bucket of masturbation tools. Take some Benadryl and masturbate, Chris. You'll be back in shape in no time. By the way, Pink Lips, you missed it. Zorg was here. I want to get up in the spaceship. Jennifer, are you on Facebook at all? Laughing my ass off. What is the question mark? What does that mean? Lol, 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 lol. Caper, what is a caper, by the way? Do you know what a caper is? Are you a cook? Do you know what a caper is? Look at my hat. It's falling apart already. I've only wore it once yesterday. I got a haircut, by the way. I don't know if you can see it. Well, maybe more than one hair. Still kind of doesn't look right on the side. Looks like I'm bald. Oh, I'm originally from Cape Breton. That's what the Cape is. No, it wasn't Atlantic City. It was Seaside Heights. I could have sworn it was where all the boardwalks are. There's a word for it. Maybe it is Atlantic City. I thought it was something else. Am I saying it right? Caper, or is it caper or capper? Now my hair looks like crap. It looked better earlier when it was all fluffy. When I came home and took my shower, I was naked in the bathtub. This damn Facebook Live wouldn't work. I said, screw it. I'm going to go on this YouTube thing. I'm going to try YouTube Live for the first freaking time. And here it is. Bada bing. I'm YouTube Live. Woo! What's going on, Pink Lips? This is where I'm at tonight. Kind of boring, but Sharon sent me a puzzle. Oh, There's a lot of messages on this Facebook land. Hold on, wait a minute. I got a new message from. Okay, I know who the Grimmins is. Looks different on her YouTube. Wow. Huh. Really? I follow your... This is a message a while ago. I follow your live discussions, and really, no one can keep it... Can be real as you keep it anymore. Quite sad, really. I'm not a crazy-ass stalker. Just wanted to know the world needs more intelligent and honest people like you. I do believe the world needs more honest people that aren't fucking assholes. Hi, Bandit. Come on. Most people are fucking assholes. They don't hold the door for people. They're just rude. Hi, where are you going, handsome? Oh, no, I'm in your spot. He wants to come to bed. Hold on, ladies. Want to see Bandit? Hi, this is Bandit. He's huge. He's bigger than me. Hi, what's happening? Hi. He wants a spot on the bed. He's not going to get it because Chris has Planet of the Sun. This is some more stuff. In case you missed it, Pink Lips, this is some stuff I got mailed. Sock monkey slippers. It's a thing. I don't know. Hold on, Bandit. I'm going to get your... I guess I'm going to go so I can make Bandit his bed of love. Sorry, I made a mistake. Seaside Heights is the shore in Ocean County, New Jersey. I couldn't remember where the boardwalk was that all those rides are. I can't think of what it is. Let me put my pop, in case you missed it, let me put my Pop-Tarts away. Bandit, lay down. In case anybody talks to Susie Q, let her know, by the way, that this is what I'm mailing her for her her beautiful granddaughter, a baby sock monkey hat. It's not a big one, just a baby one. And then hopefully maybe a costume that'll fit. I don't know. It's just like a sock monkey shirt type of thing. I don't know. So I know her granddaughter's only like one, but maybe, you know, when she hits two, by the time I mail it, it will get there. I'm horrible about mailing. I know, Pink Lips, I still have your pearls to mail. I got a long list of stuff to mail, and I'm just like, ugh. You know, who do I mail first? Canada sucks. If you mail anything, like, overseas or, you know, out of the country, they want to know what the fuck is in it. You know, you gotta write all this crap out, and I'm like, why? What the fuck? It's not a bomb, you know? There goes my sock monkey. I better put my sock monkey slippers. Yes, I'm on Facebook. My name is Jennifer. I think I've seen your name. I'm 99% sure I've seen you already. I'm gonna put my slippers in here somewhere. Oh, we'll put them in there with Ashley's Christmas gift. To Ashley, love Chris. Oh, fuck it. That's last year's Christmas. I ain't getting anybody Christmas gifts this year. I'm just gonna say, skip it. Skip to the loo. I'm not doing anything. I'm gonna take a picture of that in a minute to show Susie Q what I'm sending in her box so she can be psyched about it. All right. What's going on, ladies? I hate this comment thing because I can't see it. Don't worry about me. I'm cool. I know, but I, you know, it's like I need to mail these things. I need to get off my ass. They wouldn't let me send jewelry to a friend in Canada. I had to say it was something else. Yeah, you know, they wouldn't. They would not let me mail a candle to my friend. I mailed her a candle, wax candle. They would not let me. I had to tell her it was a electric candle with no batteries included. They do not let you. I mailed her jam. They said I'm not allowed to mail food. I had to fill out the form twice. Not allowed to mail food. What else? Everything that I mailed this poor girl, there was a problem with it. And I was just like, I had to lie. I said, I'm sending her a couple steins. Yes, Chris, sometimes you have to lie. I'm just going to say, I'm going to try to put it in a card is what I'm going to do. Put a bunch of stamps on it and bada bing. I don't know if it's going to work. We used to not need to put, if we're mailing something to Canada with stamps like a card, we used to not need to get special stamps. We just get stamps for America and whatever. We don't need Canadian stamps. But yet I saw Mina send a card and it had Canada stamp on it. Well, maybe it meant Canada. That's her stamp. I don't think you should have to get the correct country. That's me and my recycling. It's a mess. Don't ask. It's empty beer cans and crap. I need to leave this shit out for Susie, though. I don't want her to forget that I'm sending her this stuff. I'm cleaning up my house, and I'm getting rid of anything I don't want, and that's where that comes from. Except somebody did send me sock monkey stuff, and I've never had sock monkey slippers, so I might wear them. I might be all blinged up. Even though these are my slippers, here we go. I'll show you Bandit, and here's Chris's life. Let's, wait a minute. Let me, let's reverse. There's my feet and my cat. He's coming up here because he loves me. So come here. You're a good boy. Come here. Aw, look how fucking amazing you are. Look at his mane. I shaved him at the beginning because he goes outside. And he rolls in the bark mulch. And his mane, if you can see, he's a Norwegian forest cat. And his mane, he smells the cologne from Maria's thing earlier that I had out on me. Her pearl, but his mane is just starting to come back, and he's amazing and fucking handsome. Show me a paw. Go like this. Show me. Go like this.
Show me your paw. Hey, show me your paw. Good boy. You're so handsome. Aw, I love you so much. All right, well, that's Bandit. You guys get to see this. Where's Pat? Patch is actually in there with the salt lamp. He loves it. So handsome. That's a smart breed. So affectionate. Yeah, look at him. He's just a lover. Loves his ears rubbed. Good job. Yes. They're very clean. Your very clean ears. He's so white now that he doesn't go outside anymore. But he loves it. He will go outside and his fur does not, like, it penetrates all the rain. You can see the rain beat up, but it doesn't soak down to his skin. It's crazy. What are you doing? You're laying on my ghost box. You're biting wires. That's not funny. Hello? Hey. He's playing with my Twinkies. Nice. How do I see these? Deb is me. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to say. I'm going to try to put it in a card. The jewelry I'm going to put in a card thing. But I think there's more stuff in there for clips. More than jewelry. Everybody has their own, like, little bag of stuff. Some stuff is just jewelry. Some stuff is some random crap. I can't even remember what half of it was or is. To mail. Like, I forgot Maria's hat, right? I bought us months ago, back in May. This is how bad I am. Earlier, remember that orange hat you just saw me wear, this one? Earlier, and I already got stuff on it, too. What the hell? Uh-oh, I don't want to lose Zorg's hat. You missed it, Pinklip. Zorg was on here. They're gonna come take me up in their spaceship. This hat, I got me and Maria matching hats. So there's mine. Maria's in this bag with her stuff. And months ago, I had said, Maria, we're gonna do matching hats for Shmuel. Well, I set them aside with a couple headphones with the mics built in. I totally forgot about them. Then I did the pearls, and I noticed Maria posted today saying, "Hey, I never got the hats that you were gonna send me." So I said I was gonna send you one. We're gonna wear them. We're gonna match and wear them. You and me when we shmuel. And she's like, well, I never got it. And I said, I never sent it yet. She's just like ragging on me for still not sending something from May. And I get it. I know. I'm very fucking slackerish. If I had a girlfriend, she'd be like right on me. She'd be filling out these little packages and making sure everything's packed and not gonna get squished or anything. But not me. I'm kind of like, I take forever to do shit. I admit it, though. I'm not even going to lie about it. Have a good rest of your evening. Goodbye, Holly. What is going on with you? You're taking off for the night? 9:41. You know who's getting laid today? Tonight, Angela. She's up in Newfoundland, Canada. She's off at a bar tonight, and she's searching for the D. So I might shmuel later on and do a little D song, just like I did for Becky. Angela wants to get the D. Oh, yeah, Angela's scoping out tonight for the D. Yep, it's just her and her son up in Newfoundland, all lonely. They want to take a little visit to Disneyland. That'd be nice if they visited me along the way, but who wants to drive the whole coast of New England and down all the way to the East Coast? Who wants to drive? Why don't you just fly? I get car sick, so I'm a big baby. I'm just like, get me off the bus. Hopefully she's successful. Who's successful? I miss the conversation sometimes when you guys comment. Who's successful with what? Oh, finding a man. You guys comment really fast. Angela, I hope she gets laid tonight. I really do. I hope she meets a night. Not gets laid. Maybe I should rephrase it. I hope she meets somebody that wants her for more than just her sexual abilities. You know, think she's nice and stuff like that. I hope she meets a nice companion. That's the way I want to phrase it, even though I don't like to sugarcoat it. In a way, I do hope she gets the D because she probably needs it. Do you guys, I want to know Caper Chick. Do you guys, what's the word again? I can't think of it. It's not shmuel. It begins with an S. When you guys take somebody and, oh man, I can't think of it. She would know the word right off the top of my head. Not schmuck, not shmuel. There's an S word that you drink the beer, you say the poem about the cock. Screeching, yes. Why can't I remember that? I should remember owl screech. Screeching owl. But I won't. Screeching, yes. Do you guys do that in all of Canada? I'm curious, Pink Lips, if you guys screech everybody. Like, do you screech in all of Canada? Or is it just Newfoundland where you screech people? Because I want to kiss the fish. And where do you get the fish? Do you get them fish at a market? You buy a whole fish? Oh, it's just a Newfoundland thing. My cat's name is Newfie, by the way. If you want to know, I'll call him. That's his name. His name is Newfie. My daughter named him. I didn't name him. We had Boofy and we had Newfie. But my wife decided she was just going to get rid of 8 of my cats while I was away. And so now we have Newfie. This is his name. I call him Grandpa because he's an old gay cat. Hi. This is Newfie Noof, huh? I love you so much. Even though you're gay, it's okay. It's all right. You're the best gay cat ever. You are the best. You're the best gayness. I love it. I love you. Cold ears. So this is him. That's Newfie. But his nickname is Grandpa because he's like a grumpy old gay guy. You ever see a grouchy old gay guy? He's gay. He's with his furry lover. And they're just doing their gay pride with their little lights on their feet or whatever the hell they're doing. They got their bubble butts and they're hugging and loving it on each other and grabbing each other. Well, this is him. If it's a guy cat, he will just love on it. You know, what's going on with you? He likes to bite my face. You kiss a... Oh, it's a cod. I've been screeched in. You kiss a cod. We have codfish here, so that's funny. No, Noof. Come on. Come on. He wants out and he can't go out. It's inevitable. They're not going out. No. Do you want to see how tranquil my bedroom looks? Uber Goober Girl sent me this salt lamp. She's on YouTubes. I got my window open. Check it out. There's my lamp and there's my bed. It's a, like it's logs. Can you see that? It's logs and my window's open. Let's check outside the, let's look what's in Chris's world. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Hold on. I hit the wrong thing. Here we go. Oh, creepy guy in parking lot. Can you see that guy? He looks like a killer. He's not even walking a straight line. He looks like Jason. Creepy. He's totally trashed. Can you see him? He's got like chick legs. Long chick legs. He reminds me of Donna Summer. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now. Cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one that tried to hurt me with goodbye? You think I'd crumble? Do you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, no, not I. I will survive my Madonna Summer. Oh, as long as I know how to love. La, 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 la. My son's dad is a Newfie. My salt lamp is on its way. Oh, my back. I cannot do the leg kicks for the life of me. And don't play with bananas either. You'll end up eating them. Hi, Bandit. What's going on with you? I'm back, all right? I'm back and we're drinking beer. Why are you giving me the evil eye? I don't deserve it. I'm not even up to no good. You're up to no good. What are you doing with my Twinkies? Fucker. He steals weed, by the way. You're getting a salt lamp. I love the salt lamp. I want to put it behind me in this room. I need a couple little brackets for a shelf that I have for behind my bed. I got my left fireball bottles ready to go, dangling down there. Have you guys seen my let-up fireball? Watch what I did. I had a friend, Twyla, who went to jail for 5 years. She's gone. Yep, I'll see her in June. What year is it? June 20... What will it be? 2020 something? 2022? 2002? 20... Wait a minute. 2022. That's crazy. 18, 19, 20, 20. Wow, 2022. Here's my light. Watch this. Go on now, go. Walk out. I made this. One of my friends had one of these behind her, up on her, like, bed, her nightstand on her bed. And I was like, what the hell did you do? You can't just put regular average bulbs in there. They got to be tiny little LED ones. But I got bottles from everything. I've got the Jack Daniels here ready to make a freaking thing. Where's the other one? I've got far too much Jack Daniels on my hand. I got the Jack Daniels honey. I've got that ready to go. What else do we got down here? Oh, we got Debbie's favorite. I'm putting all the bottles I have ready, just ready to go. Then I got this shit. We've got the raspberry. Yep. I got another of some kind somewhere. I can't think of what it is. But I'm going to put all alcohol behind my bed, and I think it's good to, you know, encourage minors not to watch my channel. Yep, I'm just going to be like, nope. Put all alcohol there and be like, watch a different channel. I wish I could make my the whole channel adult only, but I can't. I have to go on under each video, under the Creator Studio, and post, you know, adjust it suitable for adults only. I don't want to keep getting reported or striked or whatever. And I know people, kids watch their videos and people let their kids watch. People have told me, I let my kid watch your stuff. My stuff is not for children to watch, especially a 10-year-old, a 13-year-old. Don't do it. That's my favorite, raspberry spinner. What else did, what the hell did she, did that girl drink? Whoa, it's really windy out. I'm watching on my little camera. I'm sending this camera. I'm going to undo it and send it to C. Marie. She won't give me her address. I'm not, if out of anybody, you know, the person that asked for her address, and she's going to know who sent it unless everybody asks for her address. And I'm going to give her a tracking number as soon as I mail it, so it's not like I'm going to lie to her. I don't know. I don't understand what her deal is, but she, you know, she wants to pay me for my ghost hunting stuff, and it's just stuff that I'm not even using, sitting in a box. It helps me clean my house, in reality. My son's dad is a Newfie. You know, I heard that the people in Newfoundland are just different people, but they're all Canadians, right? So they're all the same anyway. They're all pretty much cool. I like Canadians. Americans are very, I find that they're short-tempered sometimes. They like to judge. They like to see one side of a story and then be like, form an opinion. And I don't think Canadians are like that. Canadians are kind of like, not like they do their homework, but they're a little more laid back and not so quick to judge. You know, I think the Canadians see a different things in a different way. That are so friendly, Chris. They are. Canadians are different. I've been there and it's not although the ones that speak French and are rude at the bank, maybe that was just the bank. I just don't like going to the bank. You know when you take your money, you go to the bank and you want to exchange it? Well, I find that the bank has not been very, you need a humidifier. I need a humidifier. I had a vaporizer. Whoa. Did you just see that? We lost power. Shit. Oh, no. Hold on. Oh, wait a minute. Was that behind me or ahead of me? That was behind me. The wind, I was just saying, the wind is crazy here. Hold on, there's crap in my eye. I'm going to drink my beer and go get my light. We might lose power live. That's a first. Cheers, ladies. TGIF. Hold on. Excuse me. All right. Here we go. There's a strange light out there. Hold on. There's a weird, strange light. It's showing up in my... Maybe it's Zorg. If it's Zorg, I'm going. I'll put the phone down. Either that or go as live as I can get. I'm telling you, when I see them fucking out in the field, I'm going. I've got neighbors, and they like to light where Carol used to live up there. They love to light shit on there. They like to cook on their grill, and they like to fucking have friends out there. Tiki torches on the weekend, yet I can't let my cat free, but they can break all the rules in the book. Hi! He just grabbed me when I walked by. He's like, hello, hello. Hi. What's going on? Wow. What am I out here? Oh, I'm out here to get my, my special... this, in case we lose the power. I gotta be prepared. I need my radio. We just got a couple weird... Oh, great. Hi, Grandpa. What's going on? Come on. Oh, no. You're too big and heavy. Look at his little paws. Look at how big his paws are. He is polydactyl. He's got 8 paws. Hold on, let me show you the other one. Wait a minute. I wish the words would go away now. There they are, watch. He's got 8 damn paws. Ugh. 8 of them. 8 little paw pad things. Uh-oh, hold on, my robe. I just pulled the thing from my robe. It's driving me crazy. Now I have cat hair on my face again. It's tickling my nose. Lovely. You wonder why I have to blow my nose every 5 minutes. Ugh. My bed is so big and huge, up off the thing. I'm sorry I'm so fucking boring tonight. I really am. Blowing my nose in your face and swearing and burping. Yeah. Excuse me. That's what you get when you watch me. Very boring night. I guess I'm going to go and just chill out. Somebody wants to watch Netflix with me, and I told her that I would. As soon as she got her grandson to bed. Some parts of Canada that are French-speaking can be rude. I can't lie. I found that that on the Canadian border where Niagara Falls is the worst. The more you get up into Canada, Ontario, Toronto, Quebec... they're better, but for some reason at the border, I don't know. Maybe it's just rude people that don't like dealing with tourists. They're sick of dealing with tourists or something. But I find that the more you go into Canada, I don't talk a lot, so I don't ever really have issues, but, I after the first couple times I tried to do money at the border, polydactyl, yes. If you look up the word polydactyl in Wikipedia, I believe it says a certain number, like 7 toes or something. Mine, one of these cats has one more than it says. He's such a fucking anomaly. He's crazy. He's like more than they call for. Maybe it's Nugget. She's got crazy paws. She just keeps to herself, though. That's why you never see her. She's in her own little condominium over there. Yeah, you know, it's funny that I get messages, give me your address, and you know, how do you know who to trust? You really don't know who to trust. Who's not gonna use your address and, you know, cause problems for you? You don't have a clue. You know, what I tending to do is I will give my address to like one person a week, and I'll give my address, and then when they don't mail something, I don't give my address to anybody else. And then when they don't mail something, I unfriend them, and then they still don't mail something, and then nothing comes, so then I know pretty much they're not ever going to send anything. And that way I know pretty much, you know, within the next week or two, if I give my address, who's going to send what. And then when they, I should get a post office box, but... I mean, I don't get that much stuff to really, you know, to go buy a post office box is kind of crazy. I mean, I should, but I figure, you know, I don't get a lot of stuff. And I don't want to go out through traffic. And if you knew my shitty, if I got a box, it would not be in my town that I live in. Definitely not. Too much of a hassle to get through traffic just to check it during business hours. That would be hard to do. Let me know when it's my week so I can send you some. You know, it's, I don't, the funny thing is that I don't trust anybody. I'll tell you why. Somebody sent an ambulance to my house at 4:30 and then people said I lied and made it up. How am I going to notice when you look out my bedroom window and see them in the morning, right? There's nothing out there but a field. How am I going to notice an ambulance out there? I'm not. Somebody said, well, you noticed the ambulance out your window, and then you started your live, and then, no, what happened was, I was awake at 4:30, luckily. I wouldn't either, I understand. What happened was, I was awake at 4:30, I wasn't sleeping, it was crappy, I don't sleep a lot because of my back. I need to roll some kratom. That, actually, we should do that live. I promised somebody on Facebook, I promised somebody on YouTube, Vava Vicky, if her state was not illegal, that I would take some of my kratom, put it into gel caps for her, and mail her some so she could try it. And I'm against doing that because I had a couple bad, bad things. One person had tried to kill herself on the kratom that I sent, and luckily it was a state where it was legal. There are like 4 or 5 states where it's illegal. And another person, my wife's sister, how does my ex-wife not know her sister's address? It ended up being delivered to a state, but it wasn't delivered because she had moved. It came back to me, and it was all opened, and the kratom was going everywhere. And it was Indiana, and had that been, caught by the Indiana police, me mailing kratom, I would have gotten into trouble. So I don't mail any more free kratom, and it's sad. I'll tell you the honest truth. You know why? Because I had a friend who was a heroin, she did her heroin. And sadly enough, she died New Year's Eve, and she had asked me about kratom. And after those two things had happened to me, I had posted one time on my Facebook, I'll mail it to anybody that really needs it and can't afford it and want to try it. And then those two things happened to me, and I kind of put the shutdown on it and mailed it to nobody, and she had wanted some, and I did not mail it to her. And to know that I maybe could have helped her wean off of heroin, and I didn't send it, I have to live with that now the rest of my life. So if somebody has a legitimate excuse where, I really want to try kratom, I can't afford it, this or that, whatever. So I told her, I'll send you some. So what I've got to do is now take the kratom and the powder, put it into the pills, and do that for her. I can't do it when there's cats in here, that's for sure. But, yeah, oh my God is right. But anyway, the reason why I don't get my address is because somebody, one day, 4:30 in the morning, I hear dun-dun-dun-dun-dun knocking like crazy. And sometimes my doors are unlocked. The one for outside depends on, if I'm expecting people. And it was my hallway door. It was strange because people that know me don't go to that door. And I'm awake and I answer it. And then they're like, did somebody fall? And I said, no, this is 4:30 in the morning. No. And then I said, what apartment did you want? And then they confirmed it. I says, nobody here. And then I closed the door. And it was 2 EMT, paramedic people. And I didn't, I thought at first maybe it was a joke. I don't know. Maybe wrong building, whatever. So I went out to the other bedroom and looked out. And yes, I can see cars like you just saw the guy walk. I went out and that's how I noticed the ambulance. And then I started recording then. So you guys could see, everybody could see the shit that I go through. Yeah, I don't want random pizzas called in my name. And it's just bullshit. People like to mess with me, and I don't need that. I remember that day I was awake and you went live. That was crazy. I did go live. When I noticed that someone called an ambulance, I saw the ambulance out there. I went and grabbed my phone, and then I pressed record. And somebody was like, you noticed the ambulance and then you recorded. No, what got my attention was the EMTs. I don't just look out my window and see ambulances, Especially at 4:30, I'm not going to be even looking out that window. I was earlier, what the hell was I doing, getting a drink or something? But for the most part, no, I'm not looking out that window's in a separate room. I've got to get up and over there and look out, and I'm not... 4:30 in the morning, I'm not up and about to look out windows and see what's going on. It was just weird. I was expecting them to knock again, and I was going to be with it live, showing everybody how don't give your address, because this is a perfect reason why. Somebody had gotten it. I had taken a picture of a box that I... What it is, I think, too, I had an ex that was an asshole that put naked pictures of me on there. And what you'd be like, why is there naked pictures of you on there? We were basically comparing our stuff. After we started our shots, we were making comparison shots of our junk. I'm not even going to lie. And so that's why there's a picture, because I felt bad, because I said, wow, I've been on my shot for, you know, this long, and that's not, my junk is not like that. So that's where that came from. My eyes are killing me from the cat. It's amazing the shit people, yeah, I mean, and I hate to judge everybody by one bad apple, you know, by saying sorry, but that's just the way it is. But, I mean, I would love to get more free things, but I tend to give out my address very, very, to one person, and then I either wait for them to get back to me or wait, see what they're doing. Is it a fake account? You know, I don't just give it out. And I'm pretty 99% sure this woman that mailed Maria the fake rotten shit, saying that it was from Dennis, she's the one who said, can I, and she acted like to me she was going to give Maria a nice birthday gift, and she was sad she didn't get her bear on time that I sent her. I never even get the money back for that fucking bear. I sent her two bears. The first one, somebody robbed me on eBay. Never got my money. So they say, oh, you're, the lady doing the Pearl Party the other day said, you're protected on PayPal. Well, guess what? You're not fucking protected on PayPal. If you go past a certain point, eBay won't help you. When you go past a certain point, PayPal won't help you. Well, you have to get to a certain point before PayPal will even begin to help you. But once you're past that point, eBay shuts off. Once you're like past 30 days past, eBay gets rid of that shit, acting like you never bought it, yet you can't even find it on PayPal. So I can't even get reimbursed for the fucking first bear that I got Maria, which is shitty. Anyway, I don't fucking... Somebody the other day said, try Ocean Drops. This, I finally found the top to it. This is what is like Ocean Drop. It works. It doesn't have a taste or anything. It clears your nose pretty good. I'm looking for my eye drops. I'm not fucking, I'm not going to use my doll store. I'm going to use my good shit. When I pick up my cats, it absolutely drives me crazy. I need my little Refresh Plus. Hold on, guys. What are we chatting about anyway? Ambulance? Oh, my address. I want to send my address. Don't think that I don't want, you know, things from everywhere. But I do not trust people. I think the woman that lied to me, the person that sent the ambulance here, the girl had said, I'm from Scotland, and I'm going to send you, because I said I wanted to make kilts for men a thing. And she said, I'm going to send you some tartan, what do you call them? Like, scarves. I've been constantly using Clear Eyes Max. Live and learn. Wait a minute. Let me read this. I saw that. I felt horrible for... Yeah, the girl that sent Maria that stuff had messaged me asking for Maria's address. I gave it because I legitimately thought the girl was going to cheer her up. Is this live or is this Memorex? This is live, Holly. I legitimately thought the woman was nice, and I believe I know the same woman. She's asking for my address now out of the blue. No, she's not getting my fucking address. And it's shitty that I have to be an asshole and say, hey, Holly, wait, you're not Holly at Larrabee. You making up a fake name so we can get married or what? Your mom messaged me, by the way. I've been live for 3 hours. Your mom messaged me. She kind of scared me. She unfriended me from Facebook. I think she's embarrassed. She's embarrassed. She's afraid. She's running from the fucking, she's running from the haters. So, I don't know. Yeah, that's why I don't give it. Not for any other reason. Why? Why what? I get a haircut. Check it out. I'm sweating my ass off, but this is my day. I got a haircut. Yay! What was I saying? So, yeah, no, it's not that I don't, you know, I don't want nice things sent to me, because I do get a lot of stuff sent to me. You're so handsome. What are you drinking? I don't even understand. Your mom messaged me, though, and I don't know why. She's asking me questions about you. And I thought, don't ask me, ask you. But I didn't message her back because I didn't know what to say to her. My back is killing me. I tried doing my leg kicks earlier. You missed it. You missed a lot of stuff. We were going through Chris's crazy stuff I get mailed collection. Today I got a card with a weird little... today I got a beautiful card with a strange little lotion in it. And it was all over the place. And that's just to fill you in. That's what happened on my day. Zorg was here. Zorg was here. And I'm ready to get, you know, beamed up. They're coming to get me as soon as they can find me. They need to type in the right coordinates. I should have given them to them. The right latitudes and longitudes. They can come get me. Me and my alopecia. They'll come grab me. Ah! What's going on, Holly? How you doing tonight? Are you all right? I'm on here with Pink Lips and couple other people that you probably know from Facebook land, but Facebook Live doesn't work tonight. I've been constantly using... my eyes are just horrible because of the cat. I'm giving out mustache rides tonight, Holly. What's going on? La, la, la. Here I am with Bandit. Hi. What's going on? Uh-oh, you guys are saying hi to Holly. Hey, Holly, what's going on? You're bored tonight, I bet. You're bored, you're sitting there with your Miss Emma, and you're sitting and you're probably... What did you have for dinner? I had a Pop-Tart. I'm finishing the rest of it in a minute. Here's the rest of my dinner. It's Pop-Tart-a-mania. That's just it. Bored and lonely. I got a new shirt on today. Somebody sent this to me. Crazily, it's an extra large, but I'll wear it. Beer, it's your friend. Right? Well, it is. It is my friend. So tonight I'm drinking some beer because it's the weekend. It's TGIF in my land. I had a peanut butter cup, two of them. I'm having these. I'm having wild berry Pop-Tarts. Yep, that's what I'm having. All day and night. I had a banana too, right, right banana bandit. You're driving me crazy. Why? I wonder if cats can be allergic to humans. Love peanut butter cups. Did you see why my name is different? No. No, why? Why is it different? You must have got married overnight. Why do the comments keep fucking disappearing? There's no way right now I can go on this live and do a pearl party. Ever, ever, ever. Because when I'm opening this, I want to be able to look up and see shit. But there it is. Scroll up. Okay. No. No. No, what am I missing? No. What am I missing? I don't know what I'm missing. I'm up to polydactyl. I did scroll up. I don't see why. I don't get it. What am I missing? I don't want to ruin anything. Oh, crap. Hold on. Let me go on you and see what happens. Okay, actions. Report, remove. Put user in timeout? Oh, that's what I need on. That's what they need on Facebook. You can put user in timeout or block. I can put you guys in a timeout if I'm mad at you. That's awesome. It's like a 2-year-old. Oh, that's cool. Comment after I said you're so handsome. What? Hi, Caper. Hi, Debbie's. You had a peanut butter cup. That's what I'm reading. I'm missing something. I'm missing it. I don't know why you would change your name, but that's cool. I'm wearing my hat because I expect to be beamed up today in the stars to Zeta Reticuli. I talked to Zorg earlier. They're going to get me. Larrabee is my legal name. Oh, I didn't know that. Well, you find something new out every day, right? I didn't know. I get a friend named Christine Larrabee, and she is so fucking sweet. I'd say something about her, but I can't. I'm just going to say this. She lost her niece recently, and when that happened, I was like, wow. You don't realize that shit. My dumbass lawyer for my divorce didn't. Dumbass lawyer. My lawyer's, I don't have a lawyer. The one I did was a dumbass. I'm my own lawyer, though, for my divorce. And you know what the funny thing is I filed my own motion. And the lawyer had quit on my wife. He said, I'm done. The case is basically done. I resign, whatever. And then I filed my own motion. And then he says, I want back on the case. Oh, well, he's an idiot. He's a moron. He's just a stupid guy. Last time I was in there, I didn't have to go on the defendant side. I was on the plaintiff. I was like, this is great. I guess when you file a motion, you go on the plaintiff side. Well, I need to keep filing motions because this bitch is always fucked up. She hasn't had any of her damn paperwork from day one. None of her bank statements. You know, what the fuck is that? I'm in there with everything. I should file, default. I should try to figure out how to do the default on her. Put her in prison for contempt. That'd be good, but you know what? Did we really lose power earlier? Can you guys tell me? I don't think it was that shutting off. I think it was that light. I'm scared that we're going to lose power because the wind is crazy again. They don't even explain this on the news. It's not like they give us a freaking heads up. I took Claritin, and guess what? Not working. How long does this shit take to work? I'm going to take Benadryl. Screw this. I know Benadryl will work. Then I'll be sleeping in an hour. I was going to watch Netflix, but nobody, Melanie didn't say if she was going to watch Netflix back with me, so. Where are my Benadryls? What did I just do with the bag? Oh, shit. There's the bag. All right. I was going to say I put the bag somewhere. Ta-da. My bag full of allergy meds. Claritin. Can you believe there's 70 in here? How much does that shit cost? 70 Zyrtec. I bought 12 Zyrtec. I could have sworn. It was like $25. Some Flonase. I'm not putting that in my nose. Where is my... There we go. It's Christmas! Yay! I'm taking my Benadryl. It's bedtime. It's 10 o'clock at night. Let me read this. Ask for my name Carter back. So I'm stuck legally with Larrabee. So unless I absolutely have to use Larrabee... Wait, I don't understand this. Let me try to figure this out. I don't understand this. Your old name was Carter, but you got married and then you didn't get your old name back. On your YouTube on the left side of the bed and your Facebook on the right. My meds are usually right here, but they weren't. Well, I'm gonna say good night. Hope everyone has a good weekend. I can't believe how many Benadryls are in here. A whole year worth. Look at that. This should not be legal to sell. Think about this. Just saying, 365. If you were having a bad day and you wanted to take all these, I mean, there would be no hope of saving you. Just one of these knocks me the fuck out. Wait a minute. I'm going to call my mom. Oh, wait. Your mom messaged me, and she said, wait, Holly, wait. This is what she said. Hi, this is Ma. Are you going to marry my daughter, Holly? Please let me know. What am I going to say? You took it off Facebook, not me. I don't know what to say now. I'm just like sitting here just drinking a beer. I don't know what to tell her. Figure it out. You figure it out. Tell her what you want. I woke up this morning and said engaged to nobody. I said, fuck this. I'm in a bad mood now. We figured out. No, we didn't figure out Facebook last. You figured out Facebook, but it's not what you think it is. I woke up this morning and it says engaged to nobody. I said to myself, all right, it's all right. And then so I said, fuck it. I took it off of it. I just said, fuck it. Now I look like an idiot. Go look. I don't know. I woke up and it said engaged to nobody. I think I screenshotted it. I did screenshot it because Mina said, what's going on with your engagement? She dumped you already, or maybe not quite those words. No, it was Britt said she broke it off with you already, and I said, what the fuck? Because go look. We had it all right, but then nope. Then I just said, fuck it. I can't. I don't know what to say or do anymore. Maybe I did something wrong in my sleep. Sometimes my hand hits the phone, but I thought, I don't know how I can take it off of that. That's like a crazy thing to do in your sleep. Hold on. I'm getting 60 messages. Yes, tell your mom whatever you want to say. I don't know what to say to her, what to message her. Oh, it's a dinosaur. Oh, it's cute. It's a dinosaur. It's a dinosaur waving. Ah. Excuse me, I'm burping in you guys' face. All right. I am way behind on Words with Friends. I know it. Everybody's like, what the hell? My nose. Hold on. It's funny how you know what's what. Let me read you, Teresa. On YouTube, you're on the left side of the bed, and on Facebook, you're on the right side. Wait, what? I'm here. I'm on the whatever side I'm on. Why, is it opposite right now? This is where my girlfriend's gonna go, because you know what? My future wife, because I'm gonna protect her if somebody breaks in the door, I'm closer to the door, she's gonna wanna have the wall so she can be safe. She's going to be all safed in this little box over here. That's what's going to happen. I have to, you know, be here when the monsters try to get her. I'm going to call my mama. I wish I could, like, do a happy face or a thumbs up. Me, good night, guys. Catch you later. We figured out face. I know. I told my mama you're going to be our new son-in-law. Oh, good. Well, then good. Then that's good. I don't know what she was asking me questions for. I didn't understand it. I just said, I'll let you deal with it. I figured you were just busy anyway earlier doing whatever you were doing. I could not get Facebook Live for the life of me. And it was hilarious because I was all soaped up. And I thought, I got some questions to ask you guys. I want your female whatever. Somebody sent me this shirt. And so I put it on new. Somebody sent me some slippers. I had those on earlier. I shown those earlier. And so that's how my video started, was Chris getting dressed out of the shower with some stuff that people send me. When you reach for the Pearl Party paper, you reach to the left on there. In Facebook, you reach to the right. My Pearl Party paper's over here. It's right there. There's two of them. That's funny. So everything's opposite. Let me, wait a minute. The only things I can do is share a mute microphone. I can do the filters. I can do comp. I think it lets me, oh no. It doesn't even let me comment. It's show live or hide all chat messages. Or turn the camera around. That is left for us. That's funny. So it's weird. I don't think I want to go live when I do the pro party here because the messages go away. That's kind of a bad thing because on Facebook, they're down the bottom and they stay. So you guys can see what somebody writes. But on this, it deletes right away. It's like gone and I don't know who said what and I got to try to get it back. And then if my hands are all gross with remember how they were last night with all the schmegma and crap. That was disgusting. My finger, I woke up and it stung like crazy. It just looked like there was extra skin hanging off. I took a bath and then I ended up making it bleed again. Having to put a brand new Band-Aid on here again. I thought it was going to like get air. Alright, I'm going to get out of here. There are 7,000 messages now, and it's like, everybody's like, what are you doing now? What are you doing? What are you doing? I don't know. Nobody can find me, and I said I was going to go on Facebook Live, and then everybody's like, where are you at? Where are you at? Instead of message everybody, I'm just going to get out of here. I don't know what happens after this. I'm gonna hit finish. Wait a minute. Hold on. There's a like. There's a like button, but I don't know what that is. It won't do anything. I can't believe I've been 3 hours. You can go 3 hours live on here. You can't go 3 hours live on, Hi, Mia. What are you doing? How are you? You can't go live for 4 hours on, Facebook. It cuts you off. It says it gives you, like, 60-second breakdown. Let's see. Now I'm gonna hit 3 hours. 58, 59, 3 hours. Wow, it let you go 3 hours. I'm amazed. I just finally got YouTube. It was not even taking my videos over 20 minutes. Hopefully it posted my video yesterday. It was like 30. I'm good. Not doing anything but hanging out at home. That's cool. Is it like, are you having Friday day or are you like a place where it's like Saturday? Are you in America? That's my question. Are you in America where it's still Friday somewhat? Or are you somewhere else where it's typically Saturday morning? It's actually, like in Australia, for example, it's 1 p.m. I hate this because it doesn't let me creep you and I can't put my finger on your picture and find out where you live. Oh, in Kentucky. I think I know you, but your picture on Facebook is different, and it's not the same name. But you look like the same girl that I know who I'm talking to. I don't like YouTube and Facebook. It needs to sync up to where you have the same name for both, and it's not. It's kind of shitty because I'm like, if you're on YouTube, who are you on Facebook? So far, there's only one girl, though. It is Peace and Love, who will not go on. She refuses to go on Facebook. So I guess I have to have my own personal pearl party on YouTube just for Peace and Love. That ought to be fun. We'll just pearl party for one. Let's go. Let's do it. I'm going to do it, too, just for her. I will. You know me. I don't want anybody to be unhappy in this whole thing, this whole pearl party business. I'm not on Facebook, but my cousin is. She says she talks to you. Your profile picture, your little round little thing, looks like somebody that I talk to frequently from Kentucky. What is her name? I'm horrible with names. I'm good with faces, but horrible with names. All I did was pick up my cat, and my allergies are going bonkers. Who's your cousin? Where is she? Who's your cousin? Does she talk to me all the time? I talk to a bunch of Kentucky women are all right. They're crazy, but they're all right. Out of any state in America, Kentucky is the number one state. The state, what I would say, the best, cutest, sexiest, nicest women, Kentucky. Norma Mitchell. I don't know. That name doesn't look familiar, but she probably does. I talk to a lot of... You don't even know the people I talk to. I talk to so many people. She's from Louisville. Is she? I bet you she's cool if she talks to me. She has to be. She can't be mean, right? Probably. I love that. That is my favorite state, Kentucky. I've met the most nicest women. That, and then the second best is Georgia. The third I want to say is Tennessee. There's some nice Tennessee women, but I tend to not even want any women that are in America because, like, want to talk to any women. That's what I mean. Because they're just all crazy, pretty much. I think they're all going out of their minds. Canada women are, that's where it's at. What did you write? Oh, she's a sweetheart. Well, I love sweethearts. If she's a sweetheart, then I love her. Are these bubbles rotating? Hold on, this is Friday night. Oh, I've had too much to drink. Help me. Oh, they just stay there? Wait, no, they move. Do you realize weed is legal in a lot of states now? You can just go to a store and buy it. Like Walgreens. Just hop on over to the Weed R Us. What are you going to get for your weed today? They pull it out of a jar. Yes, they. I love Kentucky. Kentucky is probably the number one state for chicks. I got dance party going on right now. Most of us women in Jersey are sweethearts. I'm one of them. I don't know about Jersey. The verdict is out on that. I've got dance party. This looks like I'm all messed. Oh. No. I don't. That's scary. That's my glamour shot. My space beam. I'm waiting for Zorg. Where's Zorg? Doesn't look like nothing. 8mm. I kind of like this one. I look like I'm on film. Dawn? No. Docu? Sepia. Silver screen. Haunt. Ooh, da na 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 na. Sketch. You know what I don't like about this? I can't go live with Maria. Oh, Maria just messaged me. Do you have an angel charm to put the pink? What? Do you have an angel charm to put the... I did. You know, that's what's crappy about this. I'm going to try to go on my Facebook. Because I can go live with Maria right now, but not on YouTube. Kentucky is home of beautiful women, horses, and fast women. You're right about that. You got the derby and everything. How do I get out of this crap? Hold on. Let me show live. Mama says, just don't forget her invite. She wants to know what to wear on our day. Oh, my God. Show your live, miss. How do I get rid of this? Help me. There we go. And a heart or a cross and a white pearl. I can't message and everything all at once. Hold on. I'm going to get out of here and go on Facebook live. If you guys can follow this, I'm going to go there because Maria's asking me questions and I can't keep up.